good quarterback. He spent a lot of time last year behind Dan Orlovsky, now with the Detroit Lions. Tyler Palko really took off, and a few of his teammates after the loss at Louisville in the middle of last week saying, hey, the commitment, we need the commitment back to the way Pitt football used to be.
Well, I think, Dave, it's just a matter of frustration and something building in up inside of you. You know, he hasn't met his expectations individually, and that's been a culmination of team play that's reflected right on number three. So, you know, I think a little bit of frustration and a little bit of truth came out in some things that he said, as well as HB Blades during the week.
Need the kind of commitment that made Pitt football great here, and that's what Dave Wannstedt's trying to do as the head coach coming back to his alma mater. There's a look at Adam Gressel. He'll get us going here. Junior out of Dublin, Ohio, and we're underway. Taken at the 5-yard line. And a good stick in there as he crosses the 22-yard line. Courtney Robinson brings it up. Return of 20 yards. And Bonislavski, 4-1, starting quarterback this year. Boy, since he went down, it has been difficult, to say the least, for this young and often injured, multiple injured, Connecticut Huskies ball club.
Yeah, 0-3 since his departure, so Randy Etzel wants to get him in the game. Even if he's close to 100%, he's starting today.
First and 10 from the 22-yard line. Bonislavski going to put it in the air, first play. Zips one, and a penalty flag coming in. Penalty flag coming in, tried to get it to Brandon McLean. Make that Jason Williams on the far side. He's a senior. He's a local product out of McKeesport, Pennsylvania. So you know he's excited about being home. Pass interference. It's going to be against Pittsburgh. Jack Kramer is the referee today. Take a look at the backs and receivers. Terry Cawley, Bartsdale. Cawley's an outstanding running back. Jason Williams has 25 catches on the season. Young and Murray. Murray's pretty dependable tight end. They made some changes on the offensive line. Preston moves over to the right side. William Beatty in there. Applebaum, Keith Gray at the center. Hutcherson at the right guard. From the 32-yard line after the pass interference, first down, Connecticut. Cawley gets the carry. Ooh, did he get hit immediately? Good job in there by, that was number 41, Chris McKillop. McKillop with the tackle. He's a sophomore from Export, Pennsylvania. Along that D-line, you saw McKillop. Smith coming off of a couple of weeks where he didn't play with a knee injury. Tillman and Charles Sillett make that Sillett with the knee injuries. And then the linebackers, H.B. Blades, the number one tackler in the Big East Conference, and a lot of experience in the secondary. Second down and 11. Bonislavski gets it out to Williams. Short gain there. And he was covered by Josh Lay. Josh Lay with the tackle. There's H.B. Blades, son of Benny, nephew of Brian and Al. All made their names at the University of Miami. First team all Big East last year at the strong side linebacker spot. Probably going to make it at the middle linebacker this year, John.
Yeah, the way he's played, watch the football, and you'll see H.B. Blades lead the Big East Conference in total tackles.
So I'm getting an interception for a touchdown against Syracuse a few weeks ago. Third down and 6. Ball's at the 36-yard line.
We got two guys moving at the same time, it looked like, Dave, up on top.
Williams moved that. He was the top guy moving. Ball start goes against Connecticut, still third down.
Now, this Connecticut team has struggled, and when you've been out of the lineup, like Matt, the quarterback has been out of the lineup on Oslowski, you know, cadence is different, guys in different spots, a lot of changes on that offensive line, so that's one thing they'll need to address today is themselves staying on side.
Connecticut's the least penalized team in the league, so this is rare to see them make a mistake like this, particularly this early. Bonislavski steps up, throws short, and gets it to Terry Cawley. And not much going on there. Sam Bryant makes the tackle. That's going to bring on the punt team.
Good pursuit by Pittsburgh that time defensively. just a little dump off. Little pressure in the backfield. Bonaplowski felt the pressure, steps up. The pursuit's going to come from the edge on the right side. You can see good penetration. It forces Matt into the pocket, nowhere to dump the football. He decides to throw it to Colley, but you can see four jerseys around the catch there made by Colley.
Chris Pavaceras, Richard, sophomore out of Needham, Mass. He almost got it. He hung up a beauty. Fair catch made by Darrell Rivas. 44 yards on the punt, and a great job in there by Adam Gunn. Almost got it. Look at this layout. Just missed it. Great hang time on that punt of 4.8 seconds. Talking to Randy Etzel about that. He's just more concerned about the get-off time around.
Yeah, first things first, right?
2.1 seconds. Let's get it out of here, and I'll worry about the hang time later. Here's Pitt, first possession at its own 21-yard line. Falco's going to throw. Look out. Hangs in, got Lee. Lee, no flag, penalty flag at the 44-yard line. And they ran that deep post, and John, just pretty much what they talked, they told us yesterday, Connecticut's up close, they're going up top.
Well, they're going to have four or five guys up in the line of scrimmage in the second half. You count eight or nine guys in a five-yard box. That's going to cause Pittsburgh to go over the top. That time, Darius Butler on the coverage of Greg Lee. You're going to see that matchup all afternoon. That's what Randy Edsel said. We're going to try to put Darius Butler, our key cornerback, on Greg Lee, and from the first bell to the last whistle. And that's what you're going to see a lot of over-the-top attempts by Pitt. That's the matchup to look up today.
Got a 38-inch vertical, Darius Butler. Three interceptions, team best, and six pass breakups, the team best as well. A redshirt freshman from Tamarack, Florida. And his left hand around the waist of Greg Lee. First and 10, Pittsburgh now to 36. Nice run by Kirkley to the 41, picks up five. Kirkley, the senior, gets the start today. And for the Panthers, Kirkley, Murphy, a dependable hybrid player in the backfield. Eric Gill at tight end, Greg Lee catches a lot of passes, and Kinder has really come along. Spencer's played on the defensive line in the past. C.J. Davis, Bellani, the start at center, Simonitis, and McGlynn. Not as big a line as Pittsburgh has boasted over the last few years. Second down and five. Kirkley slowed up, did well to pick up a couple there. Good penetration initially there by Connecticut. That was Marvin Taylor who got in there to make the stop. And here's the Connecticut D-line. Maine, McPhee, Fuller, and Davis. Maine with four sacks to lead the way. Hennigan starts in the middle. Co-captain Hargrave on the outside. He's got three sacks and nine tackles for a loss. And in the secondary, we told you about Butler, Estep, Taylor, and Branch. They like Branch as well as in terms of his ability to cover one-on-one.
I would not be surprised for a little play fake and over the top there.
Toss play, Kirkley. Got a good block, first down. Right to midfield. Nice job in there by Mike McGlynn, who pulled out the sophomore from Austintown, Ohio, number 75, and he got a wipeout block on the edge.
What a great job of getting outside. You're going to see the tackle just get outside and lead the ball carrier. He's got great feet, does Mike McGlynn, and he's going to go outside and make a nice block, kickout block, on the cornerback, Branch. Great job of using his athleticism. He's a big body at 6'5", 325, but Mike can move those feet with the best of them.
Kirkley, three carries, 14 yards. Lee motions towards the formation. Here's Taco, he's got time too. Lays it out there, a little bit too high. Lee was the intended receiver. And he's covered out there, Marvin Taylor. Taylor, redshirt sophomore out of New Brunswick, New Jersey, home of the Rutgers Scarlet Knights.
Well, Matt Cavanaugh talked with us yesterday, and he was really adamant about letting Tyler Palco take shots down the field to Greg Lee. We're going to need to do that. You know, it's one thing to establish the run, but if we're going to get big chunks of offense and make it a little bit easier on ourselves, we need to go downfield, and that's what Matt, he was really stressing us yesterday, throw the football downfield.
Second down play. Kinder motions towards the formation. A waggle here by Palco. Throws and got his tight end, Steve Bukas. the junior from Pittsburgh Central Catholic, for 18 yards. That's a first down for Pittsburgh, brought down by Marvin Taylor.
Well, you love to see Palko on the move, and he does a great job with his legs. He's an athletic quarterback as well, and he's got great vision when he's out of the pocket. He picks out Bukas coming across on the crossing route. Nice adjustment by Bukas to turn his shoulders and catch the football. Just idle down, slow down, and catch the football. First things first.
First meeting, Pittsburgh and Connecticut, here in Pittsburgh, is Kirkley timing and then written out of bounds.
43 Kirkley on the carry.
And a nice play in there for Syracuse, Cody Brown, freshman from Coral Springs, Florida. Pittsburgh coming off a loss, 42-20 to Louisville back on November 3rd. That ended a three-game winning streak. Connecticut has lost three in a row. They got wiped out by West Virginia on Wednesday, November 2. That was not pretty either. West Virginia ball club is rolling. Here's an end-around penalty flag on the play. They got Lee running in open territory. Make that Marcel Pistano, freshman from Lehigh Acres in Florida, 19 yards on the game. That penalty's going to go against Connecticut. It will be declined. Pittsburgh in business here.
Good play fake by Palko in the end around to Pistano, showing good speed on the outside. No one in a white jersey within 10 yards of the ball carrier once he gets the edge, and that's something that Randy Etzel's got to, you know, makes you frustrated, because he's playing with such a youthful bunch on both sides of the ball. You have to hit the right gaps and get in the right spots, especially defensively.
Statistically, Connecticut's defense number two in the conference. Here's a running play. Kirkley broke a couple of tackles, picked up 2 yards, and he took that from a 14 to about the 12-yard line. There's Kirkley, senior out of Madison, Virginia. Ran for 560 yards last year, 6 touchdowns on the ground. This year, comes in with 325 and 1 touchdown. Nice play of this drive coming up. And there's what Pittsburgh has done in the red zone. 7 in the 18 league. 2nd and 9, ball at the 13. Falco is going to throw. That time, throws it short, throws it behind his intended receiver. That's Darryl Strong, but that was catchable. Strong, a 6'5 sophomore tight end out of Fort Lauderdale. Couldn't come up with the grab, and he's been pretty dependable on the season, John. 15 catches and almost 15 yards a pop.
Well, not the greatest of throws, Dave, but just as we saw Bukas slow down, that's what Strong has to do here. All he's doing is coming underneath. He just needs to idle down. He's already cleared the linebackers. Yes, the ball could have been out in front of him, but as Bukas slowed down and turned his shoulders, that's exactly what Strong needed to do, just idle down to keep this 9-play drive on a roll.
Coming up on 4 minutes here for the Panthers, looking at a 3rd down and 9, first possession for Pittsburgh. On the draw, it opens up for Kirkley at the 10, cuts it back, takes a good lick, and drives to the 3. It's going to be over the first down. Raymond Kirkley running hard. Marvin Taylor finally broke him down. That was a very strong run.
The offensive line doing an excellent job getting a hat on a hat. You have to give credit to Joe Villani, the center, and Simonitis did a great job making big holes up the middle on a young and inexperienced offensive line. Plenty of room to run, makes one man miss, and then runs through the tackle of Marvin Taylor.
That was good for a first down. Pitt's converted 2 for 2 on 3rd down opportunities, and Falco's going to run a timeout here. 9:03 to go in the first quarter. Randy Etzel's Connecticut Huskies against Dave Weinstadt's Pittsburgh Panthers. Panthers knocking on the door. Back with more coming up right after this.
Sport. That's why people who really go for it go for Suzuki. Cars, SUVs, and America's number one warranty. You want more out of life? We're giving you the green light. Go.
People have been waiting for this game for a long time. Packers fans are already out in force. The marching band is here as well. Coming up on the countdown to kickoff.
Are you in good hands?
This guy just went to 5 bowl games in 1 week. Of course, he forgot his sunscreen for the first 2. He lost his voice by the 4th game. And the worst part of all is his girlfriend dumped him when he got back because he didn't tell her he was going in the first place. So tell me, was it worth it?
Oh, yeah.
Enter to win Cooper Tire's Ultimate Bowl Tour, and you and 3 friends could be headed to 5 bowl games in 1 week on a private jet. Go to a Cooper dealer near you or visit ultimatebowltour.com to enter.
Who knows? This could be you.
Welcome back, everybody. Here's the score. Nothing right now on the board, 9-0-3, but Pittsburgh is in the zone, and here's this week's Suzuki walk-on way of life as we salute Joe Milani, the walk-on center. And starting, and can play on every spot on the O-line. Here's Pittsburgh knocking on the door, first and goal. At the 4-yard line, they've got 7 rush and 3 passes so far. They'll keep it on the ground. Kirkley gets about another yard closer. Marvin Taylor makes the tackle, number 10. And he had help from Danny Lansana, the outside linebacker from Harrisburg, number 48.
Let's credit that UConn defensive front that time. The Pitt offensive line has done a good job of winning the battle on the line of scrimmage, but that particular play, Davis and Fuller, McPhee, Main, a lot of guys up front for UConn doing a nice job of preventing Spencer and C.J. Davis, Villani, Simonitis, and McGlynn from getting any push inside the 5-yard line.
But Dave wants that really enforces the fact that we want to reestablish the run, and they've done a lot of that here in this first drive. Nice fake by Palka. Throwing the end zone, touchdown, Pittsburgh. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. And to Steve Bukas, the junior from Central Catholic here in Pittsburgh, has his second catch for touchdown this season. And Palko, that'll be his 15th TD score.
Great play fake by Tyler Palko and a great sell by Raymond Kirkley going over the top. Watch the elevation on the fake. He's going to get upstairs. Everybody in white looking inside and a wide open Steve Bukas to the back of the end zone for his second touchdown on the season.
There's the point after. Josh Cummings. Snap. And good. First drive. They take it all the way home. And the Panthers have a 7-0 lead over Connecticut. The running game, they established it beautifully, and a great sell by Palko. Easy toss, touchdown, Pittsburgh. My Whittick.
Hey, that's a new brand of shoe, huh?
Yeah.
How do you like your shoes?
I love them.
Shoes are good, huh? Everyone's wearing them. Who makes those shoes?
Well, Avante.
Excuse me. Do you think I could use your computer for a quick second? Okay.
At Ameritrade, we understand traders. That's why we give you the tools to spot, analyze, and seize the market's many possibilities.
Thank you.
Ameritrade, where internet equity trades are $10.99. Join now and get up to 35 free trades and $100 cash.
Great shoes, huh?
Yeah. Go to Ameritrade.com/spot or call 877-447-8330.
Is that a new sports drink?
Game On has been my theme since I came to Pitt 3 years ago. Quite simply, it means being your best, giving your best, always, every day, on the court and off the court. The Big East Conference is tough, but Pitt is a tough school, and we're a tough team. We will be ready, and we hope you come to support us.
Pitt women's basketball season tickets are on sale now. Call 1-800-643-PITT or visit us online. Pitt women's basketball. Game on.
Here's important news from Bada Cosmetic Surgery. The suspension lift will give you a look that is 10 to 15 years younger in just 1 hour. And it will generally last far longer than other lifts as a result of the superior suspension and muscle tightening performed by Dr. Bada. So isn't it time to make yourself more beautiful?
Looking younger, feeling better. Bada Cosmetic Surgery.
Call now for a free consultation to see if the suspension lift is right for you.
Today's game is brought to you by the best seats for every event. No tickets required. It only happens in one place, only Vegas. 7-0. Pittsburgh Panthers' Tyler Palko directed a 13-play, 79-yard drive at 5:08. He converses with his offensive coordinator, Matt Cavanaugh. It's going to be Robinson at the 10. And a good hit at the 15-yard line. Good collision down there. A return of 16 yards. There's the Pitt scoring drive.
17-point session on the stop.
13 plays, 79 yards.
Also,
big time off the clock, and Dave wants that. You know, Dave wants that as a believer. If you can run the football, you can win games. And if you can run and throw, well, you can win championships. And that's what Tyler Palko did and this Pitt offense did on that opening drive.
Thomas Smith with that lick there on the kick is Palko. Rest after his 15th TD. Monoslowski and Connecticut in a hole here to start this drive. Screen, they set that up. And it opens up for Calling. Takes it across the 20 to about the 25-yard line. J.J. Horn, the outside linebacker, stops him after a gain of 8 yards.
Nice job by Terry Calling, climbing the ladder to catch that football. Randy Edsall says that's our best running back. We have to use him in the running game as well as the passing game. Only 5'7", 187 pounds. He's a junior. Bad knee injury in 2003 in a non-contact situation at Virginia Tech, but he's not 100% yet, but he gives 100% on every play.
They ask him to be truthful, to regulate himself when he's tired. Hey, take a blow. We'll get somebody in there. Here's Cully. See, only going through the gap there and then hit hard by HB Blades. Can he fill a hole or what?
I'm telling you, he can run sideline to sideline, Dave. And the good thing about HB Blades, watch him go vertically. He'll go side laterally to the side. And watch him when he sees the ball carrier. Now it's north and south. He'll find him, and he's got help from the other side with Clint Sessions, who's another guy that came into the starting lineup. But HB Blades, he's the leader of this defense.
No gain on the play. We approach 7 minutes to go here in the first quarter. The draw. Bonislavski's got time. Deep out. Man there and can't connect. Tried to get it to Brandon McLean, the sophomore out of New Haven, Connecticut.
And that's one Matt would love to have back. Wide open Brandon McLean on the corner route. And all he had to do was put it close and keep it in play. That's the one thing with a quarterback that's been out of game action, getting back into game speed. It's tough to simulate that at practice, and it's tough just to step in and do it on Saturday afternoon.
7-0 Pittsburgh. Palko to Bukas. Short TD pass. Bonislavski's going to throw again. Now he's going to run. He's got the bad shoulder. Got to be careful. He slides down. Martin, he got down at the 34. Dennis Brown out of Miami, Florida. We thought he might get a shot to play, but he struggled mightily against West Virginia last week. Hernandez had been playing pretty well, runs the ball pretty effectively. Thought he might get some action as well out of Bristol, Connecticut.
Just so their moms and dads know, we were prepared to talk all about him in the open. We have plenty of material.
Andy Edsall figured, hey, my starter can go. Give it a shot. Screen left. Blown up. Nothing doing there. Brandon Young made the catch. But Pitt had seen that play, lose four on that play by Josh Lay, the senior from Aliquippa. That sets up a fourth down for the UConn Huskies. Tyler Saris is going to come on the punt again. Glad you could join us for Big East football, everybody. We're at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Connecticut taking on Pittsburgh, along with John Kinjemi. I'm Dave Sims. Thanks for joining us as we are winding down in this 05 season. Avisaris gets that one off, not nearly as long as the first one. That was Joe Del Sarto making a fair catch, a 30-yard punt, and Pittsburgh's going to have good starting position for their second drive, already leading 7-0.
See you tonight.
Okay.
Introducing the all-new Suzuki Grand Vitara. You want more out of life? Suzuki's giving you the green light. Go! Lease the all-new Suzuki Grand Vitara for just $199 a month for 30 months. Hurry in.
You know, if you're having a bunch of guys over to watch synchronized swimming, forget it. Just serve them weenies. But if you're watching football, you better be grilling Johnsonville brats. Look at them. They're big. Fresh. Always juicy. And perfect with that other home team favorite. When you give the fans what they want, well, welcome to football party heaven. Welcome to Johnsonville.
Credit bonus cash, you can get a 2006 Escape XLS 4x4 for around $19,359. Hurry, opportunity is knocking now, but it won't knock forever. See your neighborhood Ford store today.
This is it, my time to shine. Get better all the time. This is everything I wanted. This is it. This is just for me.
It targets only the gray hair. Replace it with subtle tones for a natural look in 5 easy minutes.
This is everything I wanted. This is just me.
So, Junk and Jimmy, this got to look pretty familiar. You spent a lot of your pit days at Fermanagh Brothers, huh?
That is my strike zone right there. It doesn't look that appetizing, but believe me, it'll... 2 in the morning, it is awesome.
I remember first time I came here to Pittsburgh some moons ago, and they said, you want fries with that? And I didn't realize they put the fries in the sandwich, but it works.
And for my mom and dad, that was on the way back from the library.
Yeah. Falco in trouble. There he goes. Nice play, and Pittsburgh suffers a loss here. Danny Lansana on the blitz, a loss of 13 yards.
Good play by Lanzana. Only a sophomore, youthful defense, but look at the penetration on the right side. Big bust up front from this offensive line in Pittsburgh. Falco just turned his back on the play action, had no chance to react. A nice open field tackle. Good sack by Danny Lanzana.
Larod Stevens howling a big whiff on that one, the running back. The pin in a hole, second and 22 at the 28th on the 12-yard line. Go with time. In cut, and he gets it to Strong, who holds on this time. Gets it to the 25-yard line. Picks up 7 this time. Strong is just that. Last year, 4 catches, 58 yards, up to 15 catches entering today, so that's his first.
That was a good job by the offensive line, especially on Sean Main, the defensive end. Nice throw and a good catch by Strong. And I think that's a guy in Darrell Strong they need to go after more. Pittsburgh needs to get the football to 14 because he's a big physical guy. Maybe not physical as a run blocker, but physically and got great speed vertically down the field. 15 receptions on the season.
And we saw that last time we were in here against Syracuse. As Pitt calls the timeout, yeah, he's one of those guys. You as a quarterback must love that. You look, hey, he can catch the ball. He's dependable. He's not going to drop it.
Just get it close. I mean, and especially you create matchups, Dave, that's to your advantage, especially if they try to put a linebacker who maybe not as fast as Darrell Strong and maybe not as tall and athletic. You get it close, he can make a big play.
4:11 to go here in the first. Pittsburgh's already burned 2 timeouts. And Game Plan, ESPN Game Plan features 15-plus college football games each week, so if you can't find the big game you want this Saturday, there's a good chance it's on ESPN Game Plan. And how about the games we have for you this week? USC against Cal, Kansas against Texas, and Miami against Wake Forest. Yes, indeed. ESPN Game Plan is available on TV and online. To order, call your pay-per-view provider or go to ESPN.com. And the keyword is Game Plan. Ameritrade brings you this top 25 scoreboard and Northwestern. And if the weather's good at Columbus, Bagenet might be able to do something. 7-7 ball game early on there. Florida State.
I like Clemson in this game. I really do. I think Clemson's a team that has lost a lot of close games.
They sure have. And in the Big Ten, Indiana and Michigan locked up at 7-7. Our Ameritrade scoreboard. 4:11 to go here in the first. Blitz coming. Palco saw it. Here's a flip to the flat to LaRod Stevens Howling, and not much going on there. Good defensive play by Danny Lansana again. Well done.
Just a little change up by Randy Edsel, bringing the corner Darius Butler right in the face of Tyler Palco. Tyler does the right thing in checking it down, but you'll see the blitz on the short side. Tyler just wants to get rid of the football maybe a little sooner than he would have liked, but he does the smart thing, gets it to his running back. But good defense on those three plays by UConn.
Adam Gressel, averaging 42-3, is going to be kicking to Brandon McLean. Low snap. Low line drive. McLean got a chance. Oh, tripped up. He got tripped up down there. And a good play by Pittsburgh. That was Jamil Brady. 42 yards on the punt. And the hang time only 3-2 on that line drive. Right now, let's take a look at the BCS standings, brought to you by Allstate, a proud sponsor of the Bowl Championship Series. Right now, it looks like SC and Texas, John, are headed for a collision, because I don't know if Bama can survive the rest of its schedule.
I agree with you, Dave. I think those are the two best teams in the country, and they should play.
Bama's not scoring a lot of points either. That's an issue. From the 26, Cauley breaks it. 30, 35, got the first down and more. He's in the high gear, down the sideline, and shoved out of bounds by Josh Lane. Big game by Terry Cauley, the block of beauty by Jason Williams, a gain of 35 yards.
Out of bounds by number 12, Josh Lane.
That time, Clint Session, the linebacker, he's normally in the middle. Last year, he played middle linebacker along with HB Blades, but now he's outside, and you're going to watch him. He's lined up right here. He's going to peek on the inside of this pile, and all Cauley does is bounce it outside. There's nobody to the outside. The cornerback's gone. The safety cannot come up and help and support to the short side, so just in the wrong spot could lead to a big play, and that's exactly what happened for UConn that time.
First time for Connecticut in Pittsburgh territory after the 35-yard run by Cauley. It was long in the season, 52 yards. And nice little gain out on the wing there. And they get that out. That was number 82, and that's Seth Fogarty. Chris Cauley's progress, not bad, 12.3 yards per carry.
Yeah, 100 yards, he's had 100 yards in 11 of the 23 career starts. So this guy knows how to get to triple digits running the football.
And Cauley's sixth in the Big East. Two and a half to go. Cauley will get the call. Picks up a few, but boy, there was a mountain of humanity in there. And guess who was involved? HB Blades.
Can I take a guess?
Boy, it looked like they had something going in it. Next thing you know, you see white jerseys in reverse.
You know, sometimes you talk about guys have speed, guys have size, but some guys just are football players, and that's what HB Blades is. He's just a football player. He knows his position inside and out. He's got everybody in the right spots. He tries to be a leader by example, and his example are making tackles.
Third down and 3. Rouse in motion. Lefowski's going to throw it. Checking down. Can't find anybody open. And he gets the first out. It steps out of bounds. A fine play by Matt Bonifowski, the junior from Natrona Heights, Pennsylvania, which is nearby here in Pittsburgh. Charles Sillette chases him out of bounds. They put some good pressure on.
Sillette to the left side of your screen. He's to the bottom here. He just came back from a knee injury. Maybe doesn't have that motor going at 100%, but credit Bonislawski did a great job of lifting those feet to the outside and running the football. That's what he can do. Look at his average, close to 5 yards per carry, 3 touchdowns. He has the speed to outrun Pitt's defensive front.
And Murray reset tight end right side on this first and 10 from the Pittsburgh 28, 7-0 Panthers. Blitz coming. Screen, well executed on both sides. Because Bonislawski, he was in reverse. Look at the smile on his face. He got saved. J.J. Horn was all over him, and he still got rid of it.
Good job by Bonislawski just getting rid of the football, because as you said, Dave, J.J. Horn all over. And you take a punishment sometimes on a screenplay when you let somebody come in untouched. That time, Matt was tagged up top.
Thomas Smith made a fine play in there along with Clint Sessions to make that play, and Smitty's the one that's hurt. Thomas Smith, 2-year starter defensive end. He's out of Capitol Heights, Maryland. He had 3 sacks a year ago. He's got 1 this year.
Yeah, talking Thomas Smith, tough kid. Dislocated toe, and now it looks like his leg's bothering him again. So a tough guy giving it all for the Panthers today.
Give you an idea how tough he is. H.B. Blades had some nice words about his teammate and upperclassman.
I'm comfortable with him. He's been playing in front of me since my freshman year. When I was an outside linebacker, he was at defensive end. And this year, we both made the switch to the middle. So, you know, it's just a thing. I know, you know, what he's doing and what he's thinking. You know, he's in front of me. You know, I know, you know, what he's looking at. And so I can basically fit off him, you know, because we have an understanding, and that's what I'm comfortable with.
Nice when you have that kind of teamwork.
Yeah, it's a good relationship. You know, those linebackers depend on those guys that are putting their hand down in the dirt up front.
Second down and 10 at the 28. We're under a minute and a half to go in the first quarter. Bonislawski, play fake, got time, drawn middle, got a tight end, Murray battling, and what do we have? Incomplete. Dan Murray, the junior, 6'5", out of Gloucester, Massachusetts, couldn't come up with it. He was battling Jamil Brady, a 6-footer out of Miami.
Great effort by both guys going for the football. Jamil Brady, 24 defensively. He's going to in a battle with Dan Murray. What I like about Murray, watch, the ball's up for grabs. Both of these guys, Murray elevates first, and Brady tries to strip the football on the way down. Good play on offense and defense that time. What an effort by Murray to try and go and get the football.
Cornell Brockington in the backfield now for Carly. First time we're seeing him. Play clock at 8. Third and 10 at the 28. Play clock at 4. Penalty flag. I think one of the right tackle might have moved just a little bit.
Quiet to the snap. Ball start. Offense. Number 78. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
Grant Preston, usually the left tackle, but because of injuries, moves over to right tackle today, and William Beatty's at the left tackle spot, and Grant gets called for that penalty.
Yeah, Randy Etzel, the head coach of Connecticut, really trying to fit the pieces of the puzzle up front offensively on that offensive line, moving guys around because they've been just hit with injuries on both sides of the football.
Best in the Big East. En route to that number, which you usually get per game. Bonislawski, 6 of 8 for only for 19 yards. Blitz coming, they pick it up. He steps up and now they get him. All the way back at the 37-yard line. H.B. Blades got it going, number 51. Does a great job here, John. He can run. Look at that.
Well, he does, and he picks his spot, too. He sees the double team on the inside, and he just goes right around it. He's the first guy to get to Bonislawski, but the Pitt defensive line did a nice job of rallying to the football, and he pushes, Blades pushes Matt into the fray, and that's exactly where his friends were waiting for him with Colton Hellman. So good job and good anticipation by H.B. Blades.
Joe Del Sardo back to get this Pavasaris punt. Boy, did he shoot it straight up in the air, huh? But he got too much of it. Wow, it hit off the upright.
if it doesn't hit the upright, that might hit the Mellon Arena.
That's right.
Down.
36 yards. He hit that one pretty wide.
Randy Etzel wants to know that, too.
A little shorter.
Hanging up just a little shorter.
Shane Husar has had his problem this year. Inconsistent. Only 39.2 per average on his average on punt. Panthers leading on a count of 7-0. Take over throwing 20. And here's a breakthrough secondary. This is Rashad Jennings. Jennings to the 39, a gain of 19 yards. He's their hammer in the backfield. 6'1", 235, a freshman from Forest, Virginia. Came in with 316 yards, almost 5 yards per carry.
But Dave, sometimes when you crowd the line of scrimmage, Rashid Jennings or any running back has to make the eighth or ninth guy miss. And that's exactly what happened. You're going to see UConn has everybody within 5 yards of the line of scrimmage. He's unaccounted for, the blocker on the outside. You have to make someone miss from the secondary. That's exactly what Rashid Jennings did on that play.
End of the quarter here in Pittsburgh. And the Panthers, in their final home game of the 05 season, have a 7-0 lead over the UConn Huskies. The Huskies have lost 3 consecutive games trying to end the streak. They've gone back to Bonislavski at quarterback. Will he be the answer? We'll find out in the second quarter.
Tonight at Red Roof Inn, guests get great deals at redroof.com.
Ooh, that deal's hot!
And get a great deal more than they expected.
How low can you go?
Don't miss red-hot deals from Red Roof Inn and Accor Hotel.
Where does reality end and pure vision begin? It all starts with a Pioneer plasma display, offering incredibly high contrast for a nearly 3D picture. Pure vision. Only from Pioneer.
I do enjoy drinking Guinness at a tailgating party.
Yes, and I've discovered that the local custom is to wear cheese on your head. So, to fit in, I brought along some hunks of Limburger.
Limburger cheese heads? Brilliant!
Brilliant!
I'm not so sure we're fitting in.
I smell feet.
Whatever the occasion, drink responsibly.
Brilliant!
At Red Roof Inn...
Go get him, Tiger.
We take care of you, so you can take on the world. In fact, we guarantee it.
Enjoy your stay.
The rededicated Red Roof Inn and Accor Hotel.
Heating and air conditioning.
Purchase a qualified American Standard system and make no payments until 2007. Call Geary Heating and Cooling.
Looking for a gift that's unique, delicious, fun, and can be delivered down the road or across the country? With endless possibilities for creative gifts, Cookies by Design has just what you're looking for. Cookies by Design, delivering deliciously decorated cookie gifts anywhere in the USA.
Messes seem to appear out of nowhere. So does the Dynamite Quick Vac. Lightweight power and compact storage make cleaning quick and convenient. Dirt Devil, fight dirty.
Let Molino bring samples to your home. 412-400-1000.
It is a beautiful day here in Pittsburgh. 7-0 Panthers as we get ready to start the second quarter. Alfred Fincher, outstanding middle linebacker last year for these Connecticut Huskies, now with the New Orleans Saints. Hang out with his old teammates today. From the 38, first down run here. Not much doing there as Lansana.
Rashad Jennings carrying.
Stops Rashad Jennings with help from Rahima Fuller. Numbers from the first 15 minutes. Connecticut only 19 yards on the ground. Not everything
Yeah, Connecticut's had trouble moving the football the last couple of weeks, and that's due to injury at quarterback. They get their starter back today, but the Pitt defense has answered the challenge so far in the first quarter.
Second down and 8 from the 40. Here's Paco throwing, and completion. And he gets it to Greg Lee.
Greg Lee.
Greg Lee with the catch for 12 yards. Good protection inside by Conrad Collins.
I'm not so sure if Greg Lee didn't step out of bounds when he caught this football, because Tyler Palko has a wide open receiver. Big cushion by Darius Butler. Let's see where that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that left foot steps out of bounds, and I don't know if the timing of the pass was before he steps out of bounds. They're going to talk about it on the sidelines, but you have to know where you are and realize where you are on the field, and it looks like the officials are going to give them the catch.
It's a catch, and a first down, Panthers.
Take another look, Dave. Let's see if that left foot hit catches the football. It's in the air. Looks like it's in the air still while he has the ball, so it's a good catch.
So first down for Pittsburgh.
This would be a great time play action to go right over the top.
Ooh, man in the hole. Loss of about a yard. Raheem Fuller, redshirt junior from Cocoa, Florida. He's number 93. That'll tame a running game. Goodness gracious.
Fuller fills the hole. All 6'2", 280 pounds, the junior. Doing a great job of anticipating the snap count by Tyler Palko and just beats the Pitt offensive lineman.
Did he have the radio call in his helmet? My goodness.
He might have.
Randy Etzel said he's playing the best of all the performers on the D-line. Second down and 11. Palko deep drop, max protect that time, and slip it out in the backfield. And give it to Collins, son of former Patriot running back Tony Collins. And that gain will get it to about the 44-yard line. Darius Butler covering.
28, Darius Butler got the stop.
Connors Collins, Tony is dead. Tony, an outstanding performer at the University of Kentucky for Fran Kirsten. And then again with the New England Patriots, where he teamed with Matt Cavanaugh.
That's right. Connecticut defensively, they get into their nickel package. They think they have an advantage now because they bring a lot of speed on the defensive front.
Third down at 7 at the 44. They bring the corner. It's picked up, but not on the backside. Palko in trouble. Throws it away. Was there any? Yes, there was. There was a receiver near there, and that was Rashad Jennings. Threw it right over his head. Great pressure by Hargrove. James Hargrove in a hurry, along with Anthony Rozier.
Dave, that's the speed I was talking about up front. They love to come with that nickel package. You bring guys. Anthony Rozier comes into the game, and the two big guys come out. Dan Davis goes to a down tackle. He's normally an end. James Hargrove in the backfield. So a lot of guys with athletic ability, the offensive line from Pitt that time couldn't catch up with them.
Here's Gressel.
Deep for the Huskies is 88, Brandon McClain.
I think that Cummings is punting right now. Josh Cummings, a senior from Newhall, Pennsylvania. Aiming for the corner. Does it spiral down there? It looks like a heck of a punt. It is. Great job. They're going to mark it out of bounds inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. Well done by Josh Cummings, a punt of 48 yards. Nicely done. It pins Connecticut in a hole, and the Huskies already trailing by a touchdown.
Your roadmap to the new Hyundai Tucson. Points of interest include 6 standard airbags, the government's highest crash safety rating, and electronic stability control with traction control standard. Plus, flexible cargo space with fold flat seating. With award-winning quality backed by America's best warranty. All for $3,000 less than a Honda CR-V. So plan your road trip in the new Hyundai Tucson. Starting at just $18,095 at Hyundai. Lease a new 2006 Tucson for just $199 a month at your local Hyundai dealer.
Ring 21! Prime rib! Season seared! Slow roasted at Outback!
Try something bold. Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
I'm open! Julie, will you take me to Outback for their new Hearts of Gold bronze filet with sautéed artichokes, sun-dried tomatoes, and a light lemon Alfredo sauce?
Yes, I will.
Try something bold. Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
Where can you find the most Buicks around? Sendell, Greensburg.
McDonald's Action Sports Sunday.
Live and face-to-face, our panel lets loose on the hottest topics with sports gurus from the Pittsburgh Tribune Review, ESPN Radio 1250, and special appearances by Pitt head coach Dave Wonstead.
McDonald's Action Sports Sunday, Sunday nights at 11:30 on WTAE Channel 4.
Do you suffer from fibromyalgia? Scott Medical Health Center can help. We understand how you feel and will provide you with the compassionate care you deserve. To attend a free fibromyalgia workshop, call 412-276-5394.
Driving a lemon? Car always in for repairs? You may have the right to a new car or a refund. Call attorney David Gorberg at 1-800-MY-LEMON. No cost to you.
1-800-MY-LEMON.
Got some of the Railbirds here at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh. Dave Sims and John Kinjemi with you. 12:44 to go in the second quarter as we take a look at our Hyundai Cool Facts. And the rushing game has been descending, John. What is up with that?
Well, I think it's been the level of play. You know, you go against a down Syracuse team, you run for close to 300 yards, and Cincinnati, not bad, but still 165. But then you get to Rutgers, who's been a big surprise, and then the best team in the Big East Conference, which is West Virginia, and you barely get out of the starting gate.
Well, those numbers certainly make you feel a lot better than the last time they teed it up. After the first punt of the career by Josh Cummings, they have lousy starting position, and they get it across the 10-yard line. Bryant makes the tackle. And the first catch of the day by Brandon. I believe that was first catch, second catch by Brandon. Brandon's out of Morganza, Maryland, the Hargrove Military Academy.
Sometimes when you're struggling offensively and you're not getting a lot of rhythm, might not be a bad idea to get the pace of your lineman up the line of scrimmage and get going a little bit offensively.
Good thought. Second and four. Brockington.
Whoa.
That man again, HB Blades. It looked like Brockington had a great start. His first carry, Cornell, the cousin of the great John Brockington out of Ohio State.
There was a hole there for a while, but a missed block on Blades
by
Keith Gray. And then the closing speed is what is so impressive about HB Blades. He makes open field tackles, and he makes them on a consistent basis. Today, he's got four tackles already.
Boy, Joe Schmidt and all the great linebackers out of Pittsburgh would like that one. Wow. Ricky Jackson, those kind of folks. Third down play here for Connecticut. Montefiore, that time. Flush. Now drifts it down the sideline and incomplete. Penalty flag, that's going to go against Pittsburgh. And that's a good call by the officiating crew down there. It was Jason Williams, the intended receiver, and Tez Morris put an unnecessary shot on Jason Williams, who was well out of the play and out of bounds. Not a smart decision. And Tez is a senior, but he knows better too. Four-year starter, number two tackler on the team behind HB Blades.
After the play was over, personal foul, number 20, defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
And that'll drive Dave Wonstadt and his defensive coaching staff nuts, because you just don't want to do that. You get a third down situation and the play's basically over. And here's the personal foul. I don't know. I take that back, Tez. That was not a personal foul.
I guess they say. My first look, I thought it hit him harder, to be honest with you. But he was out of bounds and the ball was not in play.
That's just a no call.
Yep. If Connecticut can take advantage. He started breaking down, and you can really get hurt like that. Darrell Revis came up. Luckily for Bonislavski, Revis was breaking down as well, because he had a free shot, could have really eliminated
him. I'm not sure if Matt's ever played baseball, because this slide needs a little work, because when you're going to get down, you got to get down
all the way.
He's a big body at 6'4", so it's a tough, a long way for him to slide, but just go ahead and get down. Don't leave that upper body exposed, because guys like Darrell Revis will take care of the rest for you.
Second down and eight at the 32. Toss play. Black Washington keeps on his feet. Beautifully done. First down, Connecticut to the 44-yard line. Nicely done. A gain of 13.
Good run, solid run by Brockington. He's a solid guy, 6'2", 203, a junior, had a terrific year last year, but he eludes a tackle in the backfield of Sam Bryant. He runs through the arm tackle and he gains about another 15 yards going north and south. Good strong running by Cornell Brockington.
This is Big East football. We come to you today from Pittsburgh at Heinz Field. Dave Simpson, John Kinjemi with you. 7-0 Pittsburgh on a Tyler Palco to Steve Bukas pass, a short one coming in the first quarter. And Connecticut trying to get on the board here. Bonifosky zips one. That's a good catch. That's to the 44-yard line, and that's Brandon Young. Good delivery by Bonislavski, making sure his guy's the only guy that can get it.
Yeah, and he threw it right by HB Blades. That one had some mustard on it. Matt reared back and fired that quick slant in there to Brandon Young. Good catch in a crowd by Brandon Young as well.
Good-looking drive by Connecticut. It started at its own 8 after an outstanding punt by Josh Cummings. All right, the previous play under review. Replay officials Robert Welch and replay communicator Don Serra. Jack Kramer's the referee. Ron Kumiega's the umpire. The head linesman's Troy Gray. The line judge is Jeffrey Cooney. Side judge is Patrick Garvey. Field judge is Bob Sokolowski. Back judge is Ron Boyd. And Jerry Ferber's the clock operator.
Go back and take a look at the quick slant. He's going to look right the whole way, and he throws it right by HB Blade. And it looked like a clean catch initially, Dave. I really didn't see anything. Maybe we'll get from the back, from the end zone shot, if he bobbles the football or it hits the ground. Looks like a clean catch there.
That, boys and girls, is a catch.
I don't think we're going to be able to show you anything that's going to change the call. This is our third look. Matt looks right and throws that quick slant down where he needed to put it. And I think the hands are under it by Brandon Young. That just looked like a good catch.
Very fine execution by Matt Bonislavski. Last year only threw it 7 times because Dan Orlovsky was the man who took it to the Motor City Bowl.
You look at Matt Bonislavski and you feel like he's a confident quarterback. I don't know. I haven't really seen Dennis
After
Brown.
Review. The play stands as called. First down.
Well, I got to look at the other quarterbacks, Dennis Brown and DJ Hernandez, in the last couple of weeks when they've played football games. But Matt looks like he's in control. And he looks like he's got a good demeanor in the huddle. It looks like everybody respects him and is attentive to what he has to say. So far this afternoon, 8 of 11 for 36 yards.
Good completion percentage. Not a lot of yardage yet. 19 until these most recent completions. As Brockington gets a nice piece of change, picks up 8 and brought down in the secondary. Darren Thomas got him. There's a look at Dennis Brown. He had a nightmare at West Virginia. 10 of 19 for 97 yards.
Strong run by Brockington. He runs through just an arm tackle of HB Blades, but good blocking up front, good pursuit by the Panthers, but you like back-to-back runs by Brockington, showing you what he can do on the ground.
3 receivers to Bonislavski's right on this second down and 3. Looks back the other way, juiced that one too much. Williams was there, had a slight crease in the defense. Blades covering on the play.
Yeah, that window was closing rapidly, and HB Blades was closing from the inside out. And he had Jason Williams in his sight. Matt Bonislavski maybe threw that one a touch too hard, but he had to try to fit it into a small window on that slant.
So let's see what Connecticut comes up with. 3rd down and 3 at the 37. 8th play of this drive. Almost 4 minutes gone in this drive. 8-3. Brockington's got it and then some. Took a defender for a ride.
Brockington up the middle.
Doug Fulmer went for a ride in there. First down for Connecticut. Good play along the offensive line here, John.
Yeah, they did a great job. The offensive tackle here, you're going to watch him get outside, go inside, and the guard pulling it around. Good down blocks by the tight end as well. So everybody doing a good job of closing down and the guard coming outside and giving some running room to this UConn offense.
Center Keith Gray got a piece of blades and knocked him down. First down here for Connecticut. Stretch play. Here's Brockington. Took a big hit. Blades again. Blades must have close to 10 tackles already. And we've got 8:25 to go in the second.
I'm getting tired watching HB make all these tackles. He can hit you from tackle to tackle. He's got great vision, and you really can't stay on him very long. Actually, nobody's on him, and that's why he's able to get to the ball carry. H.B. Blades, if you're an offensive lineman for UConn, you have to account for that middle linebacker. He's going to be around the football all afternoon.
I keep reacting because it seems like so many times a running back's neck is snapping back a little bit after Blades unloads. Second down and 5 at about the 28. Here's Bonislavski to pick up the blitz. Hangs it down there. Murray, the tight end. Oh, he was there. He had a step on the defender. He'd beaten Tez Morris to the corner. Tried to get it to Dan Murray.
That time the quarterback and tight end had different ideas of what angle they wanted to take on a corner route. Matt Bonislavski wanted him to go a little bit deeper, and it looked like Dan Murray broke off the corner route a little too sharp before he wanted to throw the football. So that'll happen sometimes when you haven't played and you're not accustomed to where guys have been running routes.
Jay Fogarty and Justin Duperettis. I think that DJ Hernandez, beg your pardon, sending in a play. Bonislavski started 6 of 7 passing. He's 2 for his last 6. Paulie's in the backfield. On this 3rd down and 6 at the 28. A lot of time throwing middle man there. First down, Connecticut, 1st and goal. At the 9-yard line, he got it to Jason Williams, the senior from McKeesport, Pennsylvania, for 19 yards.
Defensive coordinator Paul Rhodes, one of the major things he wanted to do was get to the quarterback. Well, this time, Bonislavski had all kinds of time to just sit back in that pocket and drill the dig. Paul Rhodes there on the sidelines for Pitt. That's one of the things they have not been able to do, is get to the quarterback. And they have too much time that time.
Offense. Second catch of the day by Williams. Cawley gets the carry. And he dives into the pile. Not a lot going on there. It's a guy who threw it up there. 91. Nice job.
Yeah, Phil Tillman.
Yeah, Phil Tillman did a nice job. Joppatown High School, Edgewood, Maryland, with the Valley Forge Military Academy.
Another one of those seniors playing their last home games here for the Panthers.
7-0, Pittsburgh, and they scored that touchdown in the first quarter. 14th play of the drive. Blake Bach running down. Bonislavski, long count, toss play. This will be Cawley. Oh, he tripped over the old. Oh, man, a blade of grass got him, for crying out loud. Penalty flag on the play. He's crossing the 10-yard line, and then, whoop. Reminded me of some of the days in basketball at the Boston Garden when all of a sudden
yeah.
You get a funky bounce. Oh, I'm
board.
Sorry, the ball's going to go this way. You're going in for a layup? Oh, excuse me.
And it looked like he had an escort to the outside. Just
he's
a lot
okay.
of running with
he's
William
okay.
Beattie.
Stumbled.
And then he, yeah.
Something happened with his left foot.
Offense. Number 1. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Still 2nd down.
That's a big one. Emmanuel Hutcherson, the Richard freshman from Palatka, Florida.
Yeah, the penalties starting to pile up for the Huskies. You can see the numbers on the season. They were the best in the Big East. Today, 35 yards in penalties, and we haven't reached halftime.
Randy Etzel's got to feel pretty good about the way his team's moving the ball. He just needs points, for crying out loud. Coming up on 6 minutes to go. It's been a very impressive drive. Well called and well executed. 2nd and 17, back at the 17-yard line. Bonislavski's going to throw it. He's got time. Throws over the middle. Ooh, sticking down at the 9-yard line. Josh Lay put a lick on Brandon McLean. 8 yards on the connection.
Again, plenty of time for Bonislavski to sit back in the pocket and let Brandon McLean clear. The only thing Brandon needs to do is settle down in the hole. Here's the hole right here. But he runs into coverage on the outside. He runs into Josh Lay. All he had to do was settle down, and he would have been able to go right back up the middle.
What's your call here? Who did they go to? That's a big one here.
I'd like to go to the tight end, Dan Murray, on the short side.
Okay. 3rd down and 9. 5.5 to go. 2nd quarter. Connecticut trying to tie it up. got time in there, and he did go for Murray. And threw it a little wide. Good call, John. Dan Murray was the intended receiver.
Pressure on the play by Gus Mustakas, the freshman out of Cooper City, Florida. Good job getting over the block of Terry Cauley. But the tight end running a little corner route, he had just another second. He probably could have got the football to the back of the end zone. A little more touch, tried to fit it in on a line, but good coverage by the Panthers.
Matt Nuzzi, 10 of 16 on the season, kicking field goals, a 26-yard attempt. Snap place for kicking is blocked. And Pitt, if they can pick it up, can score. Let's see. Down the sideline. What kind of legs we talking about? It's Josh Lay. He is going to score. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. 71 yards, and the Panthers take a 13-0 lead. The kicking game has been problematic all season for Connecticut. And they get victimized one more time.
Yeah, it looked like Darrell Rivas, Dave, number 25, the sophomore from Aliquippa, comes on the left side and gets a clean block. You'll see 25 right there, top of your screen. He blocks it, keeps his feet.
Wow, he came in cleanly, didn't he?
Yeah, both cornerbacks. No one touches Darrell Rivas.
Point after is good by Cummings. So the Panthers take advantage of a mistake. Cash it in. 5:07 to go. And you talk about demoralizing. Connecticut goes from their own 8-yard line, attempts a 26-yard field goal, has it blocked and give up 7. And now they trail by the count of 14-0. Big turnaround here at Heinz Field.
If you're looking for answers from an auto parts store, get ready. Advance Auto Parts is working harder to help you save money by doing it yourself. Get ready for certified experts who are ready to help. Get ready for answers on any project you can easily understand. Get ready for in-depth information from Advanced TV, our exclusive in-store how-to network. Get ready to go from no way to know-how. For all the advice you'll ever need, the first place to go is Advanced Auto Parts.
We're ready in advance.
Some finer points of the all-new Hyundai Sonata. It has more interior space than Camry or Accord, plus standard electronic stability control and 6 standard airbags, with quality backed by America's best warranty. All for $4,500 less than Accord. The all-new, fuel-efficient Hyundai Sonata. Nicely equipped at just $17,995. It's a Hyundai like you've never seen before. Lease the all-new Hyundai Sonata for just $179 a month at your Hyundai dealer.
With Dish Network's everyday low price, you simply get more TV for less. In fact, you could save about $29 a month with Dish Network. That's about $350 a year in savings. So what are you waiting for? Call for Dish Network's everyday low price right now and save about $29 a month. Plus, if you sign up today, you'll get over 60 channels for only $19.99 a month for the first 3 months. And you'll also get HBO, Cinemax, and Showtime free for the first 3 months. Call Dish Network now.
Dish Network. Better TV for all.
Pool tables, game tables, bars and bar stools. It's all at West Penn Billiards, the number one dealer in the USA.
No one else has more fun than West Penn Billiards.
At Irwin Bank, you can always expect the best rates on home equity loans. Take advantage now of our low interest rates at 4.99%. Our loan programs include low fees and affordable payments packaged to fit your needs, not ours. Irwin Bank, we exceed your expectations.
Talk about turning things around. Dave wants that, reinforcing things to the defense that saw Connecticut have the ball for 7 minutes and 37 seconds and get nothing. Rivas comes in cleanly for the block.
Comes in off the left side, and he lets his partner in crime, the other cornerback, Josh Lay, pick up the loose football and just go the distance for the Panthers. And for UConn, how demoralizing. You control clock, you control the game, the pace of the game, and you give up 7 points as a result. 71-yard return.
Here's a high short kick. It's gonna bounce and taken by Butler. Oh yes, Pittsburgh, they're starting to load now. Wow, what a hit. That was Adam Gunn. Second time we've called his name on special teams. 5:04 to go, second quarter. Panthers by 2 scores.
Your forecast calls for the new Hyundai Santa Fe. With its standard V6 engine, standard ABS and traction control, and standard front side impact airbags. Not to mention award-winning quality that lets Hyundai offer America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. All for a sunny $4,800 less than a Toyota Highlander when comparably equipped. The Hyundai Santa Fe. Nicely equipped at $20,244. At Hyundai. Get a 2005 Hyundai Santa Fe with up to $3,000 cash back at your local Hyundai dealer.
I do enjoy drinking Guinness at a tailgating party.
Yes, and I've discovered that the local custom is to wear cheese on your head. So, to fit in, I brought along some hunks of Limburger.
Limburger cheese heads? Brilliant!
Brilliant!
I'm not so sure we're fitting in.
I smell feet.
Whatever the occasion, drink responsibly.
Brilliant!
Opportunity is knocking now, but it won't knock forever. See your neighborhood Ford store today.
Where do you go when you have questions about financing a home?
The S&T Bank Home Center. Everything you need for home finance is under one roof.
Flexible mortgages and terms?
Of course.
Construction loans?
Absolutely.
Home equity loans and lines of credit?
Yep, and much more.
Visit the Home Center at your neighborhood S&T Bank.
Or go online at stbank.com.
S&T Bank.
Relationship banking. One customer at a time.
Marvin Taylor, starting free safety, member of the kick return team. I think you got a little friendly fire here on this kickoff.
Yeah, coming down the middle of the screen, the ball bounces in front of him, and he's just going to get
hit.
Oh,
his own guy got him.
His own guy right here. In the middle of that pile, it was the wedge buster, but his own guy's got him in the back. And that's just, they've been just decimated with injuries this season.
19 players off of their preseason depth chart injured. There's Bonaslavski, home run ball down there. Wow, it came out of his hand poorly. He tried to get it into Brendan Young. Well, Revis covering.
Second and 10 for the Huskies.
First three drives for Buck 43. Last week, 129.
Yeah, they couldn't do much last week, and that was more of themselves trying to get out of their own way, and West Virginia really putting the hammer to them down in Morgantown.
Connecticut coming in with the sixth-ranked offense, passing offense in the Big East. Stretch play to Brockington running hard. And injuries, way too many. Look at that. 11 surgeries.
Okay, I've never heard of 6 ACLs on one team, and we're still, you know, we have a couple games left to go.
And look at it, 8 starters in a 2-week span.
Yeah.
I mean,
that'll kill any team.
Dark cloud, huh? Well, it's not getting any easier here. A 3rd and 5 at the 28. 4:25 to go in the second and down 14-0. Flush. And he's got the first down. Nice running. Ooh, and it's sliding a little bit better. Tell you what, he really is setting himself up to get hammered if he doesn't get down quickly enough. Because somebody's going to come up on that defensive play and not stop. Not look to get, start breaking down.
You're
and
right.
If you get a chance to load, guess what?
Well, good job initially of getting out of the pressure of the pocket. HB Blades coming to the top. Everybody's in man coverage, so they have their back turned to the quarterback. And a good slot. I'm going to give that 7.58, Dave. That's getting better.
I'm like the old Russian judge on that. I might have given him a 6.5. Dude, you got to get down. 17 yards. Thought he had something. Bonaslavski shows some nice wheels and good patience over them. Picks up some positive yardage. Picks up about 3. Chase out of bounds.
Dave, you have to credit the defensive secondary that time, and Dave wants that, trying to get his message across to his defense, but nowhere to throw the football for Matt Bonislawski. That was just good coverage and a smart play by the junior quarterback. You're going to see everybody's locked up on the outside. There's nowhere to throw the football as we roll this out. Bonislawski's going to come back. He's going to look left first. You're going to see everybody covered to the left side, and up top, there's blue jerseys running with white jerseys. So a good job of getting what you can out of a bad play.
Toss play coming near side. And Brocking will be about a yard short of a first down. Nice run as he got a good block from William Beatty, the left tackle.
Sure like this 1-2 punch of Terry Cauley and Brockington. Brockington's a tough runner. He's got some speed to the outside, but I like how he just starts downhill and he doesn't hesitate. Lets his blocking clear in front of him. Then he's not afraid to stick his nose inside and go downhill.
Sam Bryant, number 46, strong safety, made the tackle. Approaching 3 minutes to go, a third and one. Connecticut could really use this one. Hesitated, and it proved to be costly. Clint Session, the junior out of Pompano Beach, Florida, makes a big play for Pittsburgh. Moves about a yard and a half, 2 yards.
Yeah, nice tackle for loss. Clint Session's going to shoot the gap. Nobody gets him. H.B. Blaze had his back, but the first guy there from Ely High School in Pompano Beach is Clint Session.
So Randy Etzel going to go for it here. Down 14-0, coming up on 2.5 to go in the first half. Play clock running down. They better make a decision here. Looks like they're going to just run it down and take a timeout. Play clock at one, and there it is. They call a timeout. The ball is at the 48-yard line of Pittsburgh. Take this opportunity right now to look at the upcoming schedules for Connecticut and Pittsburgh, brought to you by Advance Auto Parts. Connecticut with South Florida. We saw them last week. Matter of fact, we'll see South Florida next week. And then number 23, Louisville. And then Pittsburgh has the backyard brawl. It's at Morgantown, West Virginia. That's Thanksgiving evening, 8 p.m. That's a good way to finish off the Turkey Day.
It really is. And Pittsburgh, you know, both teams have their hands full. UConn with South Florida and Louisville. But with this Pitt football team, they can make amends for earlier in the season when they gave away a game at Ohio. They just didn't play well, and then they come back and lose by a point at Nebraska. So that can make up their season if they get in a chance to win today and then go down to Morgantown and have a chance to win that football game.
I think Pitt fans flinch at the mere mention of Ohio, that game given away. South Florida will see them next week. The Bulls, we'll see them next week against Cincinnati. Louisville, we'll show you highlights of what they did to Rutgers last night. Rutgers now at 3-3. And Syracuse playing South Florida today as they retire the number 44 up in Orange Country. Hope they have a good crowd up there. Syracuse,
yeah.
Jim Brown, the Greats coming back.
Should be a great day up in the dome.
At least if they have to. And that punt is going to serve Connecticut well. Down inside the one, that Pavasaris did a good job. He'll get 47 yards out of that punt. So nice job by Chris, who's a Richard sophomore out of Needham, Massachusetts. Well, next week, sadly, our 2005 package comes to a close, and we look forward to a visit to Tampa, Florida. We'll see the Cincinnati Bearcats take on the Bulls of South Florida, and that's an impressive South Florida team. Got that good Florida speed. Cincinnati got its head handed to it by West Virginia the other day, but that's a young club in a couple of years. Look out, they could be somebody to reckon with. Mark D'Antonio, the head coach, 14-0. He's got to get out of the end zone.
I don't think he did. Fumble. Pitt may have the football inside the 1 yard line.
Tell you what, those bodies are inside the end zone.
I think a Pitt lineman was on top of that football, and it was across the goal line, but it's inside the 1 yard line.
Good call.
And that will make Dave Wonsett a little anxious on the sideline.
I love the job by the umpire. Ron Fumiega gets down on his hands and knees to see who made the recovery.
There's the ball on the ground.
Boy, how did Connecticut not get that one?
I don't know. it looked like James Hargrave, 32 and white, was going to get on this football for the Huskies. He's the guy, the first man down on the ground. And it looked like Chris Vangus, 64, for the Panthers, may have got the football back.
Yep. John Baranowski, number 92, had a shot at it for Connecticut. Just missed it.
And it's not fun down on the bottom of those piles. There's a lot of bad things that are exchanged and a lot of wrestling going on down.
Hey, yeah, look at this, the referee, the umpire getting physical. Ron Kumiega, oh, right in the small of the back, Riley. Oh, my goodness, he's trying to do his job.
They got to get that guy WWE. The ref getting in there.
The umpire, that's Ron Kumiega.
Yeah, Ron.
Oh, man.
He was going for the figure four there, Dave.
Pittsburgh's got to get it out of here. Leading 2-0 by two scores, 14-0. Falco's going to throw. Doesn't have much room to retreat. Got a man running free, and that's a heck of an attempt for an interception, but Marvin Taylor could come up with it. Good for Marvin that he's back in the game after incurring that injury. All in the kickoff return.
Yeah, two-man route after the play action, and good center field play by Marvin Taylor. As you said, Dave, hurt on that special teams play by his own man and almost lays out and gets the interception. Good effort. Yeah, but it's off.
Third down and 10 from the one. Connecticut has one timeout remaining, 1:53 on the clock. Margin for error for Falco. Why not just wedge it out, give yourself a touch more room?
Well, if you're UConn, you might want to take a timeout here.
See if they do. Clock is 1:49. Good call. So Connecticut take the timeout. Final one. Always a pleasure visiting with Dave Wonstadt. Visited with him yesterday. Coming up at halftime, Biggie Saxon from earlier in the week. And we're going to check in with Mike Hall at our ESPNU studio for a preview of tonight's action and stats and highlights coming your way from this first half. Big day in the SEC. Auburn, Georgia a little later on.
How about South Carolina and Florida visiting them? The and ball coach is ready.
I love how, you know, all week, you know, you got people who aren't big Spurrier fans are not rooting for them. Great day here in Pittsburgh. Weather-wise, you could not ask for more. Somebody out in the boat, how about that? Wrestle into punt. Is long on the season at 67 yards, and I'd like him to dial one up right here, right in front of the goalpost. See, he's got only about a foot to play with, so that snap's got to be on the money. O-liner. Turnable. Took a bounce. Still got a return here. That's McQueen. With the return, a 48-yard punt. So no timeouts remaining. And 1:43 to go.
Still a lot of time, though, Dave. 1:38 on the clock. Pitt leading 14-0, but Matt Bonislawski has enough time that when those chains move, the clock's going to stop. So he can use the entire football field. He just doesn't have to work on the edges.
39-yard line. Good starting position here for Connecticut as Murray resets. That's going to throw a blitz and they get it to Pauley on the screen. And Clint Session was the first one. And then he had help from H.B. Blaze. There's your timeout story. Pitt has one timeout remaining. 1 yard on the game.
You called it, Dave. Clint Sessions, the first guy here, the outside linebacker. Look at him fight off the block, get right around the block of Grant Preston, and then he's the first guy to the reception.
Across to the throw, got time. Head down. Keeps it alive, and now the side. man to beat. And that was Brendan Young. That'll be a first down for Connecticut at the 9 at the 8-yard line. A gain of 20 yards, of 30 yards on that play.
Great ad lib by Matt Bonislavski, doing a good job of sliding to his right, getting out of the pocket and out of the pressure. And he just has the presence of mind to let Brandon Young slip past the defender, and then it's a foot race to the end zone. Inside the 10, down to the 8, UConn knocking on the door once again.
61-6 left. No timeouts remaining for Connecticut. Huskies trail 14-0 here in Pittsburgh. Hanging in, throws it towards the end zone and throws it away. Well done by Matt Bonislavski. Live for another play. That'll set up a second and goal with 54 seconds left.
The boys talking on the sidelines. Can you believe that Keith Gray did that to me? But a good job by Matt picking up the football, and then he does another smart thing. Just throw it away. Don't make a bad play worse.
Keith Gray with a bad snap at Worcester, Mass. Doherty High School. Bad break there, but bailed out by his quarterback. Second goal for the 8. Toss play. Brockington cuts it up, and he's down to about the 2. They're going to have to line up quickly. 45 seconds in counting. Set up a third down and goal.
Yeah, the offense needs to get the urgency. They've got guys coming in and out of the lineup, and we've got 35 seconds in counting, so Bonislavski needs to get organized and get his troops up to the line of scrimmage.
Third down and 2. Clock runs at 25 seconds. We have wide side of the field to the top of the screen. Clock at 20 seconds. In motion, Murray. Murray sets left side. Blitz, Bonislavski in trouble, hangs, fires, no, incomplete with 6 seconds remaining. Clint Session with the pressure. And they tried to get it to Brendan McLean.
Brandon almost made a spectacular catch in the back of the end zone, but credit Clint Session hanging all over the legs of Matt Bonislavski. Matt does a great job of eluding the pressure and then having the presence of mind to throw it deep into the end zone, maybe just a yard off, but a good job, and you almost have a great play by the junior quarterback.
Newsy from 20 yards left hash. They get it off this time. He got it up quickly and high. Penalty flag on the play, however, after the good kick. So let's see what the call is all about.
Pitt has 12 players on the field, I believe.
You see somebody sneak on. Let's see. 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So if this Randy Etzel take it off the board and go for 6, what's he do? He's going to go for it. Yeah, he's going to go for the touchdown.
I think so.
Yeah, he's going for it. I saw him wave, and you saw a couple of guys react to the sideline. They liked it.
Yeah.
Offside defense. That penalty is declined. Personal foul, leaping on the defense. That penalty is accepted. Half the distance to the goal line. First down.
So he's going to take 3 off the board and go for it. That's a big moment here.
Yeah,
3 seconds to go. 4th and goal at the 2. At the 1.5. Connecticut is going to go for it. What a statement being made here as Barksdale and Brockington are the upbacks.
And the Panthers.
And Pittsburgh calls a timeout. Randy Etzel taking those dice, blowing on them. See what happens here.
They've only been down there twice, and they've come away once with no points. That time they do get the field goal opportunity, and they make it, take the points off the board, and they're going to try to get in for 7.
7-0 Pittsburgh to start the game in the first quarter. Palco, 2 yards to Bukas. 13 plays, 79 yards and 508. Second quarter, Lay returns a blocked field goal, a 26-yard attempt. Revis blocked it, got in cleanly. Lay takes it home, 71 yards, 14-0 Pitt. Now Randy Edsel's club puts a three on the board, and look at the determination on his face.
Yeah.
I want a touchdown, and I want it now.
You know, in speaking with Randy Edsel, you see that side of him, you know, on a Friday. But then on Saturday, when he has to get down and dirty, he can do it with his offensive linemen. And he looks squarely at Cornell Brockington, and it looks like, you know, you're getting the football. So get ready to go up and over. Whatever you have to do, get into the end zone. And that offensive line, whatever you guys need to do, you have to win this battle, because this is their chance to get right back in this football game.
Doubt about it.
Go into halftime with some momentum and go in only down seven.
Randy Edsel comes from a long line of some terrific coaches. He was on a staff at Syracuse with Jim Tressel, George O'Leary, Gary Blackman, Dave Campbell, Ivan Fears, and Clarence Brooks. But here we go. Big point in this game. Connecticut taking a three off the board. They want to trade it in for seven. Rockington to deep back. Bartels the up back. Wide side of the field to Bonislavski's right. Rockington gets the call. He didn't make it. Did he make it? Let's see. He did not make it. I believe it was Blades that got inside and got those ankles.
Great effort by the Pitt defensive line. It looked like there was a crease for Brockington to get into the end zone, but it looked like his knee touched before he's able to get that football across the goal line.
Blades did get him.
H.B. Blades is going to come across from right to left.
Now the play's under review, John.
Well, I'm not sure if he got the ball across before his knee touched. It looked like Brockington his knees were down before he reaches the ball over the goal line. Let's take a look right there.
Oh, his knees are down. Yeah, he reached it across. That knee was down.
I think it was after he had touched.
How about Blades
this
getting in
there? This is the best angle. Yeah, you're right, Dave. Blades comes in late. I don't think that's six, Dave. I think he was down before. And there was another Pitt Panther around the leg of Brockington.
Actually, there's Blades on top. Who was somebody? Was somebody underneath?
That's good effort.
First guy was fifth. That's who it was.
Yeah, Duncan.
Rashad Duncan was the first guy. I saw a 5-0 number. So he was the one that made the big play. Big gamble, say the least. Last drive for Connecticut went 15 plays and got no points. No timeout. No time left on the clock. Reviewable plays here in the Big East Conference. End zone, side, goal, and inline play.
Correct. The half is over. No touchdown.
Connecticut turned away. And boy, they'll have to stew in that one during halftime. Big play by Rashad Duncan, freshman from Belgrade, Florida. Stops Connecticut at the goal line. Pittsburgh at the half has a 14-0 lead. Palco to Bukas, and then the 71-yard return of a blocked field goal. Dave wants that through. Leads by two touchdowns.
I got to say, UConn's recruiting efforts have really paid off.
This incoming class is even more talented than last year.
These kids could have gone anywhere. A lot of top universities wanted them.
They sure did. Check out this lineup. An incoming class with nearly 100 valedictorians and salutatorians.
Honor students with average SAT scores of almost 1,400.
More than a third of incoming students graduated at the top of their high school class.
No wonder UConn is ranked one of the nation's top public universities.
UConn is amazing!
Your guide to the all-new Hyundai Sonata. With the government's highest crash safety rating and standard safety features like six airbags, electronic stability control, and active front head restraints. Plus, award-winning quality backed by America's best warranty. All for $4,500 less than Accord. The all-new Hyundai Sonata. Nicely equipped at $17,995. It's a Hyundai like you've never seen before. Lease the all-new Hyundai Sonata for just $179 a month at your Hyundai dealer.
tailgater with a few brats under his belt knows if you don't turn them, you burn them. So, if you're going to jockey those Johnsonville brats around the grill, come prepared. Or at least, prepared to improvise. Welcome to Heaven on a Bun. Welcome to Johnsonville.
Before you go here, before you attempt this, and before you even think about going there, you need to go here. Cooper Discoverer Tires, built to take you just about anywhere. Cooper Tires, don't give up a thing.
During number one Cochran's November sales blitz, you'll save big on more makes, models, and colors than you can imagine.
I like them all, except the browns. Just not into the browns.
Now, at number one Cochran's, look for Pontiac G6 sedans from just $159 a month. GMC Envoy 4x4s from $279 a month, plus tons more. Hurry to number one Cochran before the clock runs out.
Carl Herman Furs, for over 100 years, deeply committed to providing the finest quality furs, leathers, and shearlings. The best there is, for less than you can imagine. Carl Herman Furs, downtown Pittsburgh.
Fitness and fun come together at Gymkhana Gymnastics School. Programs for infants and toddlers to competitive teens. All ages and gymnastic abilities have fun at our three locations. Phone 412-247-4800. Gymkhana.
24-hour service, immediate coverage, and the easiest payment plan in the industry. In other words, getting coverage from Safe Auto Insurance is a lot like this commercial.
Simple.
Welcome, everybody, to our ESPN Plus Halftime Report. We come to you from Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, where the Panthers have a 14-0 lead over the Connecticut Huskies. And a dramatic end to the first half, with the Huskies taking three off the board and going for six and don't get it. Dave Sims and John Kinjimmy. Wow. I mean, if you just suck the air right out of Connecticut, unbelievable. Take a look at the standings in the Big East Conference as we enter play this afternoon. West Virginia in charge right now, but South Florida, should it win out, can win the Big East Championship. They have the season finale against West Virginia.
Yeah, and Louisville, all they can do is watch and hope for something to happen, but West Virginia right now, the dominant team in the Big East Conference.
Speaking of the Mountaineers, just a few nights ago, they were in action at Cincinnati, and it turned out to be an absolute whitewash. Steve Slayton, again, big time, 25 rushes for 129 yards and four touchdowns, and that offensive line for West Virginia was just domineering.
Yeah, and Pat White, he's done a good job of running the football and running the offense, but it's been all Slayton. The freshman has done a terrific job of finding holes and making big plays for that Mountaineer offense.
Pat White had 211 all-purpose yards, 111 on the ground, 8 carries, and 7 of 12 passing for 100 yards, and they win it by a final of 38-0. And then last night, Rutgers on the road at Louisville, they stomped on the Cardinal logo. That was a mistake.
Not a good idea.
Goodness gracious. To run it in here, early score, and next thing you know, the game got out of hand. Brian Brohm was brilliant, 22 of 30, 315 yards, 3 touchdowns, and no interceptions. And there you have it. West Virginia 38-0 as we check the Ameritrade scoreboard. That's from Wednesday. And then last night it was Louisville just wiping out Rutgers 56-5. And in progress right now, just underway, South Florida at Syracuse. No score in that game. Syracuse trying to get its first win in the conference. South Florida, as we mentioned, has a chance to win the Big East Conference by running the table. Some of the sights here at the old steel town, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. More halftime coming your way with Mike Hall and ESPNU after this.
Oh.
awesome.
Wow. And I love being a trader. Living for the moment, baby.
Yeah, but is that all we're about? I mean, I love being a trader, but I also have an investing side. Like, I want to open a B&B.
B&B?
Well,
a B&B?
That's awesome.
You know what? I've always wanted to write a children's book.
What about?
Ponies.
You know what? I put money aside every month, and I'm going to open up a shelter for abused dogs.
See, that's wonderful.
Time to embrace your investing side. At Ameritrade, you'll find products and services to help you plan and invest for your goals.
Hey, Jeff, how about you?
Well, I have been thinking about opening a dance school.
Let's see some moves.
Call 888-396-6001 or go to Ameritrade.com/invest to get up to 35 free trades and $100 cash.
So, I got a wake-up call from my family about the taste and smell of our drinking water. I guess I've just gotten used to it. My neighbor said, call Culligan. She was right. They really fixed the problem. Now, not only is our water cleaner, everything tastes better. Coffee, pasta, soup, even the ice cubes. So take my advice. For your family, just say, hey, Culligan man. I did.
It's fall savings days. Call your local Culligan man for his special offer on renting or buying. Act now.
For over 33 years, employee-owned ThermaTwin has been improving homes. We manufacture and install the best and most dependable windows, doors, and sunrooms in the market today.
Want to know the secret to our success? It's our employee-owned.
We're all owners!
Because ThermaTwin is employee-owned, our quality and craftsmanship is supported by our employee pride. We manufacture and you save. This month, we're offering 33% off your total purchase. Call us today to arrange your free in-home estimate or visit us at our showroom.
Do you suffer from pain or numbness in your back or legs? You may be suffering from spinal stenosis. Scott's Medical Health Center can help. To attend a free spinal stenosis workshop, call 412-276-5394.
Driving a lemon? Car always in for repairs? You may have the right to a new car or a refund. Call attorney David Gorberg at 1-800-MY-LEMON. No cost to you.
1-800-MY-LEMON.
Steelers football Sunday night means special times for ABC shows. Catch America's Funniest Home Videos Sunday afternoon at 1. Then Extreme Makeover Home Edition at 2. After the game, an all-new Desperate Housewives Sunday late night at 12:30 a.m. Followed by an all-new Grey's Anatomy at 1:30 a.m.
Here's the right way to buy a Saab. Go to Wright Saab of Wexford. Lease the new 9.3 sports sedan for only $329 a month. Turbocharged performance. Scandinavian design. Born from jets. Buy Saab. Right.
Hope you enjoyed your first half. Welcoming you into a cootie-free zone here at College Football Front. Tom Luganville, Steve Israel, I'm Mike Hall. Look ahead to the games tonight. Start off with the SEC. The big one is Auburn and Georgia. It's a Bulldog team that's had to play without their quarterback recently, but finally they get him back. What does this do to that team, Iz?
It gives them an emotional lift. And what I mean by that is DJ Shockley is their senior quarterback. He's a leader, and more importantly than that, he is well-respected on this team on both sides of the ball. His strength is running the ball. However, he's not going to be 100%. So Coach Mark Richt has to be smart and utilize his talent, which is throwing the ball to this big guy, Leonard Pope. They have to utilize him. But if Georgia expect to do a great job against Auburn, they're going to have to get a lot of bite out of their tailbacks, Thomas Brown and Danny Ware.
Well, that's exactly right, and they better be able to run the football to keep the ball away from Auburn. This is two football teams that can run the football well. They play sound defense. So I think this game's going to come down to the play of the quarterback, in particular, Brandon Cox. Auburn can grind yards out on the ground. But every time they've been a big game this year so far, the opener against Georgia Tech and then against LSU, Brandon Cox has not played as well as his team has needed to. He better step up this week. I think if he plays well, guys, I think that Auburn will have an excellent chance of winning this football game.
If the Dogs win this, they clinch a spot in the SEC championship game, which means that game, if they win, they will be in a BCS bowl. Right now, let's look at where the standings are, and we see USC still up top, Texas, Alabama, then Miami, Penn State. Now, this is coming in. This is the top 10 before this week's play. Oregon is the interesting team. They're sitting at number 10. This evening, they'll play Washington State. Their only loss in the season is USC. Tommy, can we say this team is a legitimate BCS bowl contender?
Oh, I think they certainly are. I'm so surprised at how well that they played against Cal after losing their quarterback, Kellen Clemens. Kellen Clemens was playing about as good a football as any quarterback in the country when he went down. But they've been able to make up for it with Brady Leaf. He's come in. He's young. He's still learning. Coach Mike Bellotti, offensive coordinator Gary Croton, who I played for at Georgia Tech, have done a great job adjusting the offense around their youth now at quarterback. They are physical on defense. They can run the football, but the quarterback position has not gotten them in trouble. We got the big win in overtime versus Cal a week ago.
You know what, Tommy, one thing that will help them is running the ball. I know Croton loves throwing the ball, and this kid is coming and do a great job, but Terrence Whitehead has over 500 yards rushing. He had 119 last week versus Cal, and he's arguably the best tailback in the
Yeah,
history.
And they've been helping out this offense, which, as you see, they're 16th in 1A with over 450 yards every single game. They're averaging 34 points a game, so they've been pretty impressive so far. And pretty impressive is something you could say about UCLA up until last week. They finally get their first loss of the season, and it's an ugly one against a team from the state of Arizona. They face another team from the state of Arizona now. Is how do they bounce back in this game?
I tell you, when I was a kid, I watched a movie called The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, starring Clint Eastwood. UCLA's good, Drew Oldson, Maurice Drew. Bad, their defense. Ugly, that shellacking they took last week versus Arizona. But the good thing is this, it's past tense. They have a strong offense to run behind with their star runner here, Maurice Drew. The one thing they have to do is just regroup on defense and try to find some type of defense to bounce back, Tommy.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Two words that can describe both of these football teams. Rushing defense. Neither one of these ball clubs can stop the run, and UCLA got exposed a week ago. It was only a matter of time. People kept talking about the UCLA-USC matchup. UCLA wasn't going to beat USC because they can't stop the run. They're going to struggle to stop the run, I think, against Arizona State. However, Arizona State's going to struggle to stop the run as well. This thing could be a high-scoring affair because neither team can stop each other.
Sure, and watch out for Arizona State throwing the ball, too. They're second in the nation in throwing the ball in terms of yardage.
If UCLA does have a little tiny strength on defense, it's their secondary. It's not quite as bad as their run defense.
There we go. Tom and Steve, I'm Mike. Thanks for watching us, and we hope you enjoy your second half.
Years ago, the University of Pittsburgh developed the first vaccine that conquered polio. In the 1980s, we became the world's leading center for organ transplantation. Today, our researchers continue at the forefront of medical breakthroughs, targeting cancer, Alzheimer's, and other debilitating diseases in our quest to improve human health. The University of Pittsburgh. We're building the future together.
Something bold. Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
I'm open. Julie, will you take me to Outback for their new Hearts of Gold bronze filet with sautéed artichokes, sun-dried tomatoes, and a light lemon Alfredo sauce?
Yes, I will.
Try something bold. Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
What does a plumber in Los Angeles have in common with a CPA in Chicago?
Finally, I found quality health insurance that's affordable.
And so did I, thanks to MegaHealth.
Almost 500,000 individuals and self-employed Americans already rely on the Mega Life and Health Insurance Company for their quality, affordable health insurance. And now, so can you.
Call us for a free quote and discover the mega difference for yourself.
It's getting individual attention from a licensed agent who helped me tailor a plan to match my needs.
It's the ability to choose my own doctor and know that my claims will be paid. Call us for your free quote because you never know when you'll need the mega difference. It's being able to afford quality health insurance for myself and my family. Quality health insurance at affordable rates for working individuals. That's the mega difference.
Call 1-800-701-5473 today for your free quote. The call and the quote are free and there's no obligation. So call 1-800-701-5473.
During Number One Cochran's November sales blitz, you'll save big on more makes, models, and colors than you can imagine.
I like them all, except the browns.
just not into the Browns.
Now, at number one Cochran, look for Pontiac G6 sedans from just $159 a month. GMC Envoy 4x4s from $279 a month, plus tons more. Hurry to number one Cochran before the clock runs out.
Tired of those high energy bills? Then stop throwing money out those old drafty windows. Now is the time to call Window World. We'll come to you with free consultation and professionally install your beautiful new windows. Easy to open, easy to clean, virtually maintenance free. Don't miss this opportunity to get any size double hung vinyl replacement window installed for only $189. Quality name brand windows at guaranteed lowest prices or double the difference back. Window World, simply the best for less.
You have a creative side. You see endless possibilities in an empty space. You're fascinated by color and texture. You're a visionary at heart. In interior design at the Art Institute of Pittsburgh, we'll work with you to develop your talent to create practical solutions for the real world. Your art becomes your voice. Interior design, the Art Institute of Pittsburgh, 1-800-278-1172.
Fort Pitt Bridge takes you right into downtown Pittsburgh, and we're just in the shadow of that bridge. First half highlights, and John, a couple of big plays here.
Yeah, a couple of nice drives. Tyler Falco with a great fake, and he gets the football to the back of the end zone to Steve Bukas, his second touchdown on the season. 13 plays, 79 yards, and then the big block on the outside. Darrell Revis gets the block, and Bernard Josh Lake takes it the distance, and that's where we stand now. 14 points for the Panthers, and at the end of the half, Brockington trying to get in. He stopped short inside the one-yard line. Great play up front by Duncan.
And what an emotional end for Paul Rhodes in that Pittsburgh defensive unit, and the Panthers are going to get the ball to start the third quarter.
This is really an exciting time to be in the Big East Conference, as we welcome three new teams.
The Cincinnati Bearcats.
Louisville Cardinals.
And USF Bulls.
We also welcome two new coaches.
Dave Wanstead, Pitt.
Greg Robinson, Syracuse.
This is the new Big East.
Building a bright future.
On a foundation of rich tradition.
With a BCS bid to the champion.
Welcome to hard-hitting, exciting football.
Every week in the Big East Conference.
People have been waiting for this game for a long time. In fact, the fans are already out in force. The marching band is here as well. Coming up on the campus kickoff. Hey! Hey!
Are you in good hands?
If you're looking for answers from an auto parts store, get ready. Advance Auto Parts is working harder to help you save money by doing it yourself. Get ready for certified experts who are ready to help. Get ready for answers on any project you can easily understand. Get ready for in-depth information from Advance TV, our exclusive in-store how-to network. Get ready to go from no way to know-how. For all the advice you'll ever need, the first place to go is Advance Auto Parts.
I make my living 8 seconds at a time in the world's toughest sport. So when I'm not battling one of these, I'm riding one of these. Whether I'm on the trail, I'm on the ranch, or on the hunt, ain't nothing tougher than my Grizzly.
For a limited time, get a worn winch for just $69.95 plus low monthly financing.
Golf Digest is going to Cure Your Slice now and for free.
And that's a guarantee.
Introducing the breakthrough video, Cure Your Slice Now, and it's free with your paid subscription to Golf Digest magazine. In this video, top PGA instructor Chuck Cook shows you the seven key phases of the swing and gives you his proven method for better control and longer, straighter drives. And here's our guarantee. If Golf Digest and Cure Your Slice Now doesn't cure your slice and improve your game, cancel and keep the video free.
Golf Digest is your source for golf.
Every month in Golf Digest, you get easy-to-follow tips and instruction from the best teachers and players in golf. Information on the top equipment, the best places to play, thought-provoking commentary. You also get this removable pocket tips booklet. Call now. Use your credit card and get your first risk-free issue, pocket tips booklet, and video free. You get 11 more issues for only $19.77. If your game doesn't improve, cancel and keep the video, booklet, and magazine free.
So call 800-543-6200. That's 800-543-6200. Call now.
Matt Boniswowski got the start today, put up some good numbers, but nothing on the scoreboard. 14-0 Pittsburgh. Tyler Palko has the TD pass to his credit, a short two-yarder to Steve Bukas. And Pittsburgh's going to get the ball to start the third quarter. And if you're Pittsburgh, you would love nothing more to eat clock and punch in a seventh spot right here. Here's the kick, about a yard deep. Darrell Allen, he's got room. Oh, good stick. Running straight up and down. He took a big pop from Darius Butler. 30 yards on the return. Stat. Here we go. 19 minutes and 25 seconds. Time of possession for Connecticut. Nothing. Rushing yards, more than 2-1. Passing yards, more than 2-1.
First down.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, it looks like the score should be flip-flop.
Sure enough.
30-yard return for Allen.
Look at that. A buck 44 in the second quarter. Nada. The scoreboard. That really hurt. Yeah, defense has to do a job here.
Yeah, it doesn't matter if you can't cash in at the end of your drive.
Got to break it to the outside. Nice little wiggle there by Larod Stephen Talley. Ninth and biggest rushing this year, the freshman from Johnstown, Pennsylvania. Just 5'7", a buck 65.
Yeah, but Matt Cavanaugh says he's a tough kid, Dave. He's got the normal nicks and bumps and bruises, but he's got great speed, and he'll make you miss, and he's got the elusiveness and the strength to break those arm tackles behind the line of scrimmage.
Did a good job last week. Returned after an ankle injury a couple of weeks ago. Ooh, that time. He got hit hard. Danny Lansana. Say one thing, this Connecticut defense shows up, and that's a 2-by for you.
Yeah, Deion McPhee, number 76 up front, the senior. Wow, there was four or five white jerseys waiting for Stevens Howling.
Thank you, coach, for giving me a blow. Listen to this.
You don't think that UConn's come out of that halftime talk with their head coach and Randy Etzel's got him going?
Take a pretty big chip on their shoulder. First clock running down. Palko just got it off. Short drop, slant, good. First down. And a heck of a job to fight for another yard or two. That's a nice job. They got it in to Derek Kinder. Kinder, sophomore from Albion, New York. First catch of the day.
And that's a good job by Palko, getting out of the play, and a great catch by Kinder in traffic. Three white jerseys, branch all over his back, but he has the strength to hang on to the football. Good recognition by Tyler Palko. Looked like UConn defensively showed their cards a little early in what they wanted to do.
31st catch by Kinder, and another good lick. I'm telling you, these kids are bringing it. They are doing a nice job. MJ Estep comes up from the strong safety position. He's out of Mechanicsville, Maryland. Good play.
Yeah, real good play. And along with Dan Davis, number six, right side of your screen, you'll see the pursuit come in. There you see Estep, and Dan Davis was on the other side preventing the cutback. So good job by Estep coming in down from that safety spot.
Ranked number two defensively in the Big East Conference. Lee in motion towards the formation. Palko, that time, steps up, throws short. Lee with a catch, his second, taken down almost immediately. 2-yard gain. Boy, that's your home run hitter, and you're sending him underneath those 2-yard patterns. Co-captain James Hargrave makes the stop.
Yeah, not much room to look downfield. Had some time in the pocket. You see Greg Lee streaking across. He looked like he was wide open, but it's zone coverage. When it's zone coverage, you don't have to go that fast, Dave. You miss, you pass up the holds. You're supposed to stop and catch the football and turn up and go north and south. Greg needs to recognize that and idle down a little bit. Two catches on the afternoon, and that's it. That's a big surprise.
He and Kinder combined for just three on the day. Blitz coming. Picked up. Falco's got time. Swings it. And it's driven away. Kirkley was wide open.
That's good pressure by James Hargrave. Again, back-to-back plays. Hargrave around the football, really making Tyler Palko feel a little uncomfortable in the pocket. And Matt Kavanaugh's down there telling him, hey, you know, that time you could have stepped back behind the pressure. Tyler Palko didn't do anything to elude the pressure that time in the pocket.
Adam Gressel's on the punt. And that's a fabulous defensive stand. You look at Brandon McLean. Great work by the Connecticut defense. Forced this punt. Gressel took his time, hangs it up nicely. McLean, fair catch signal, makes it at about the 13-yard line. 40 yards on the punt. So can the Connecticut offense get it in the end zone? H.P. Blade's going to have a lot to say about stopping them. He certainly has in the first half. Seemingly he was all over the field. He made plays in the first 30 minutes, sort of like this.
You love his aggression and getting to the football. He has a nose for the football. And there's a reason why he leads the Big East in total tackles.
Well, when he hits you, you stay stopped. Clint Session in on the stop there, along with Chris McKillop.
There are the numbers on H. Fleet for the afternoon. 7 tackles, 1 sack, and 115 total tackles. Terrific young man and a great football player.
14-0 Pittsburgh. Palko TD pass and a 71-yard return of a block field goal by Josh Lay. Second down and 10 here for Connecticut. Matasovsky fakes the draw, and he's got a man running free. He threw it to the second man, and he makes the catch at the 32-yard line, but that was it. Brandon Young. But running free was Brandon McLean, running a deep post pattern, 18 yards on the play. John, did you see
McLean? Yeah, I think you're right, Dave. That was a good read, but a miss. He had the home run down the field, but a spectacular catch by Brandon Young. Watch Young come back for this football, twist his body, and just make a great hands catch. Good catch.
Ball at the 31-yard line. They'll run it up the middle, going nowhere, is Brockington, brought down by Phil Tillman. Second big play we've seen him make today. You're just joining us, 14-0 Pitt. Connecticut, with about 3 seconds to go, put a field goal on the board. Penalty against Pittsburgh. Randy Edsel says, you know what, we're going to put 6 on the board. Give it to Brockington, trying to run off a right guard. And he got stopped, and that's how the half ended. And then Pittsburgh gets the ball to start the second half. And a good defensive stand by Connecticut. And now the Huskies have the ball for the first time here in the second half. On a delay, Brockington for a couple. Brought down by Clint Session. These veteran players, guys like Morris, Revis, Lay, Session, we've been calling their names for 4 years. Strong performers.
Yeah, they've done a nice job. And it seems like right now, Pittsburgh defensively making UConn work for everything they get. And nothing's come easy, and they've had to control the football and move it down the field to get in scoring opportunities. So what UConn needs to do now on third down, make a big play to shorten the field.
The Connecticut's got 5 receivers for this one, 3rd and 7, at its own 34-yard line. They blitz from the edge. Look out! Down goes Bonaslavski. J.J. Horn with the sack, his second. He was unaccounted for. He got a clean shot and made the most of it.
And he got away with a hand going to the helmet, too, of Bonaslavski.
7 yards on the loss.
Nobody picked up J.J. Horn. He comes in untouched. You can see that right hand get around the helmet of Matt Bonaslavski. He wasn't called for it, but a good job by the Panthers on third down.
Pavasaris with the punt, and they let it roll. Won't do too much damage. Cost them about 8 or 9 yards. A 52-yard punt. Limited hang time at 3-9 by Pavasaris. Pittsburgh's going to start at its own 21, leading by the count of 14-0.
Enjoy drinking Guinness at a tailgating party. Yes, and I've discovered that the local custom is to wear cheese on your head. So, to fit in, I brought along some hunks of Limburger.
Limburger cheese heads? Brilliant! Brilliant!
I'm not so sure we're fitting in.
I smell feet.
Whatever the occasion, drink responsibly.
Brilliant!
Welcome to Ranger Country, where the redesigned Polaris Ranger with available electronic fuel injection outruns, outcarries, outhauls, outpulls, and outrides every utility vehicle out there. The Polaris Ranger, now with available electronic fuel injection. The hardest working, smoothest riding off-road utility vehicle you can buy.
People have been waiting for this game for a long time. In fact, the fans are already out in force. The marching band is here as well. Coming up on the campus, kickoff. Hey! Hey!
Are you in good hands?
This guy just went to 5 bowl games in 1 week. Of course, he forgot his sunscreen for the first 2. He lost his voice by the 4th game. And the worst part of all is his girlfriend dumped him when he got back because he didn't tell her he was going in the first place. So tell me, was it worth it?
Oh, yeah. Enter to win Cooper Tire's Ultimate Bowl Tour, and you and 3 friends could be headed to 5 bowl games in 1 week on a private jet. Go to a Cooper dealer near you or visit ultimatebowltour.com to enter.
Who knows? This could be you.
Next week, the Big East Game of the Week heads south as the Cincinnati Bearcats race into Tampa to take on the South Florida Bulls. The Big East Game of the Week next Saturday at noon Eastern for only from ESPN Plus. Glad you could join us, everybody. We're in Pittsburgh. There's a look at Greg Lee. Has not had a big day. Panthers starting this drive at their own 21. Falco, deep drive. He's swinging out. And he's got Stephen Hallen. And he gets hit down hard at the 24-yard line by Darius Butler. Do they have something up top?
Yeah, Dave, they had Greg Lee. If Tyler Falco just would have had a little bit of patience on the play, and you don't know how they're calling it from the sideline, so maybe the play's designed to get out of his hand a little bit quicker, but I would look for the Panthers, if they're going to try to put the nail in the coffin here, go deep to Greg Lee and take a shot. When Connecticut goes man-to-man coverage, you got to go to your playmaker outside.
Greg Lee, number one in yards per game, catching the ball in the Big East at 89.4 yards. A non-factor today. Almost a good defensive play. Stephen Hallen on the outside. Penalty flag, I think it's going to be on Greg Lee. Ryan Hennigan forced him out of bounds. There might be a block in the back on the far side, John.
Yeah, or a hold out there. It looked like Greg Lee had some hand fighting going on outside with the cornerback because the play took a long time to get to the outside. They may have caught him for a hold.
Holding. Offense. Number 86. 10-yard penalty. Still second down.
So Greg Lee called for that infraction. Jack Kramer, the referee today.
And you have to give credit to Greg Lee. He's out there and he's battling the cornerback, and the corner's doing a good job. But at the last minute, the flag comes in, and I don't know if it's a hold. I mean, this looks like there was some infighting on the outside. And that's the matchup between Darius Butler and Greg Lee. We thought we'd see that down the field on a pass attempt and not with infighting on blocking.
Second and 9 at the 22 after that penalty tackle. Steps up, got a man running free, and it's his tight end, Gill. Eric Gill, first down, Pittsburgh, to the 47-yard line. First catch made by Eric. And Gill, big catch there, and that's his first. Picks up 15.
Terrific feat by
25, Davis.
Excuse me. Terrific feat by Tyler Palko in the pocket. Steps up and delivers a strike just over the linebacker's reach. Terrific job by Palko, and the linebackers have to get a hand on Eric Gill. You just can't let that tight end go and waltz down the middle of the football field. Good throw and good catch.
From the 47-yard line, Palko, 10 of 15 for 85 yards. We'll put it up again. Deep middle, man there, diving attempted to give it to him. Yes, sir, Kinder. Oh, no, the back judge said no. He didn't do it, but a great effort by Derek Kinder.
We're going to get a good look at Kinder to see if he comes down with the football. Attacking the middle, there's the ball on the ground. Looks like it hit the ground and changes direction, Dave. I think that's a pretty good call. Looks like the ball, he had the football, but once it goes to the ground, it changes direction. You can see the corner, the end of the football turn. But I think that's a good call. I don't know if it was a catch.
Back judge Ron Boyd on that call. Here's another look.
The ball gets through his hands and gets to the ground. His hands aren't underneath the football. It's on either side of the football. So I think that's a good call.
Second down and 10. Pitt at its own 47. To the ground. And
Fowling up the middle.
To the 50-yard line. Long memories of these Pitt fans. They're not happy.
Don't you love when the crowd just disagrees with the call? It's just perfect for the setting right here. But third down now for Pittsburgh. You have to make a play if you're Tyler Palco, and you would think you want to go back to the middle of the football field.
He's got Kinder in the slot top of the screen. Lee flanked outside him. Got about 8 in the box. Blitz accounted for. Palco now taken down. They overran him on the edge. Good job by Anthony Rozier, the freshman out of Amherst, Massachusetts. And that's a loss of 10 yards on the play.
When you bring 8, you have to count on your receivers to break off the routes and get open. That time Palco goes back, he hits his 5th step. The ball should be gone, but no one in a blue jersey breaking away from anybody in a white jersey. So good presence of mind by the staff on Connecticut to come after Palco, bring 8. And you can't block them all. And Anthony Rozier comes in for the sack.
Wrestle the punt. Boy, hit one nicely here. Fair catch, 15-yard line. That hung for a long time. 44 yards, a hang time of 4-8. Nicely done. 5:51 to go in the third. Pittsburgh by 2 scores.
Catch all of the premier regional college football matchups only from ESPN Plus. Check the local listings for each Saturday's game and time in your area. ESPN Plus is the best source to follow your hometown team.
Try something bold. Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
I'm open. Julie, will you take me to Outback for their new Heart of Gold bronze filet with sautéed artichokes, sun-dried tomatoes, and a light lemon Alfredo sauce?
Yes, I will.
Try something bold. Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
With 24-hour service, immediate coverage, and the easiest payment plan in the business, Safe Auto Insurance is easy to get. What's hard is telling people you didn't when you had the chance.
Well, it's quarterback and the center making sure they got everything together here for the Pittsburgh series. 14-0. Panthers on top of the Connecticut Huskies. We check in with the Ameritrade scoreboard. South Florida on track. It's where the Bulls want to be. Run the table, they win the Big East Conference. And Syracuse, the struggle continues. First and 10. Connecticut being shut out here in Pittsburgh. 5:51 to go in the third. deep drop on his cross. He went back, looked for a deep ball, nothing there. And throws it away. Closest person there is Clint Session. John, put your hand on why they can't complete the deep ball. What's going on?
Well, you know what? You have to give credit to the Pitt secondary. They're doing a nice job of staying in coverage, and it looks like both teams have had more success over the middle of the football field on the in routes or the seam routes, so you'd want to come back to that. But on that particular play, I think it was just good defense that prevents the quarterback, Bonaclasky, from throwing the football downfield.
Second and 10 at the 16. Keep it on the ground. Here's Rocky's in. Boy, he got a face full of Tez Morris, didn't he? Penalty flag on the play. Gain out to about the 24-yard line, and that's going to be coming back. And a lot of penalties for Connecticut today. The Huskies, the least penalized team coming into the game, and they've had a bunch today.
Still second down.
57, Matt Applebaum called for the hold. Junior out of Yardley, Pennsylvania, just on the other side of the river from Trenton, Philly suburb.
There's been some hitting going on today. There you see Tez Morris coming up, the senior from Hamilton, Ohio. Big hit.
So what's your play call here? You got second and 18, and you're backed up.
I might want to throw a wide receiver screen outside of the top.
All right. Run a draw instead. Brockington, maybe three. 4 yards. Clint Sessions cleaning up the play. Phil Tillman slowed him up. H.B. Blaze got a piece of that tackle as well.
Yeah, second and long, Dave. You want to get something back so you have, you know, you're closer to third and 10 or third and 8, so you have a legitimate chance to pick up the first down, and now you're third and 14, backed up inside of your own 15-yard line. So.
Paul Rhodes said a jailbreak here.
You know, you might want to pressure. You're doing a good job. You might want to bring one more than they can block because you've done a good job covering downfield.
Third and 14 at the 12. Everybody moving up. Tez Marsh right now, a deep back. Now they rotate back. Rush three down linemen. Bonaflowski, deep ball. Oh, he should have had it. That was an interception. Tez Morris, what happened? He had a gimme. That's why he's a DB.
He took the words right out of my mouth, and it looked like Matt Bonaflowski had some pressure from behind in Charles Sillette, but you got to catch that football if you're the Panthers. If you're waiting, playing center field, you're in perfect position, and you probably gain about 20 yards in your field position if you catch and run.
Bubba Saris standing a yard deep in the end zone, a sick punt. They got a piece of it. I think they did. Bounced at about the 28-yard line. I think somebody got a piece of that. Pittsburgh in golden position right now. Adam Gunn, who has done an outstanding job on special teams this afternoon, and you can't beat this starting position in Connecticut's backyard, already up 14-0.
This season, catch all of the premier regional college football matchups only from ESPN Plus. Check the local listings for each Saturday's game and time in your area.
Any tailgater with a few brats under his belt knows if you don't turn them, you burn them. So, if you're going to jockey those Johnsonville brats around the grill, come prepared. Or at least, prepared to improvise. Welcome to Heaven on a Bun. Welcome to Johnsonville.
It's the final days of Pontiac's new release party. Your chance to experience the most new models in our history. Get to your dealer by November 14th for a limited time new release bonus on the purchase or lease of a new G6 coupe, an award-winning G6 sedan. The Pontiac G6 starts at $16,490. Pontiac's new release bonus ends November 14th. Don't be late. Pontiac, designed for action.
I always thought that water was just water. Now that I have crystal clear Culligan water, everything's great.
Our water tastes wonderful and laundry stains are a distant memory.
Western Pennsylvania Culligan dealers hear it all the time. They've been providing local water expertise for over 60 years. That's three generations. Rely on Culligan's world-famous service from local businessmen who are just a phone call away.
It's fall savings days. Call your local Culligan man for his special offer on renting or buying. Act now.
Hey, Culligan man!
14-0. Pittsburgh, late third quarter. And they have unbelievable starting position here after a 16-yard punt. Let's take a look at our Ameritrade scoreboard. Notre Dame putting it on Navy again. Navy's been so close the last three, 4 years. It's amazing. Today may not qualify. Ohio State running the Wildcats out of Columbus.
The old ball goes.
Yeah, he's smiling going into the third quarter.
Steve Sperrier getting it done, and Oklahoma State out early on Texas Tech. They had that same thing going for them against Texas a couple of weeks ago, and wound up getting blown out.
Man-to-man coverage, take a shot.
They are outside, and catch. Get it to Kinder. Picks up about nine. Pittsburgh trying to go for the kill here, late third. Kinder's done a nice job today.
Well, he's been a good surprise, and a surprise for Pittsburgh. After the opening drive, you go 12 plays and 79 yards, and you come back and punt the football five times. You get a good play on special teams that results in 6 points. So Dave wants that. The recipe that this offense needed was a short field. Well, they have it now. Let's see if they can take advantage.
Pittsburgh just 70 total yards since the first drive.
Watch a quick slam here, Dave.
Couple wides to the top. Now too much time. Time ran out on a play clock. That's okay. Not good.
Number three. 5 yard penalty. Still second down.
And that's a mistake that Dave wants that Matt Kavanaugh will shrug off and address tomorrow, because they don't want to show emotion right now to Tyler Palko how upset they are when you take a delay of game penalty, especially when you have the football inside the 25-yard line. You're trying to put the game away.
In other words, we don't want to be in the film room tomorrow morning?
Well, I mean, it might blow over if they go on and win this game, but it'll definitely be addressed.
Second down, short drop. Palko throws off the back foot, goes to the tight end. He loves the tight end today. Gill, why not? Look at Gill fight. Gill's driving. He makes it six. They can't bring him down. They can only throw him down. Gill sets up a first and goal for Pittsburgh. The kind of hit fire you see over the years, in the old days at least.
Eric Gill showing some toughness, and Pittsburgh taking a page out of the USC Reggie Bush push drill inside the 5 yard line. Watch Gill go up and get the football in man coverage. Now he's just pumping his leg. Here comes some help from behind. Let's push the pile. Good job by Dominic Williams and everybody else trying to help out Bukas. But a good catch by Eric Gill.
Nice job there, and testimonial to doing a lot of squat. Just Kirkley denied. He left maybe a little bit too soon. The guys in the strength training department here at Pitt gotta love that, right? When you see a guy drive, I mean, the place is dead.
Their work just begins when the season ends.
Well, it is really important for Pittsburgh to get a touchdown here. They want that Matt Kavanaugh. Three-score lead would really put Connecticut in desperation mode. Kirksey's first rush. As Palko dives, he's up.
No indication yet, but here it is.
Touchdown Pittsburgh. So Palko tacks on another six. It's 20-0 Pittsburgh. A big play that catch and run by Eric Gill.
Palko getting airborne inside the three. Just reaches the football over the goal line. You can see it on the bottom right here, and it took the linesman to come in and say, okay, yeah, touchdown.
The short punt, which was partially blocked, second block punt of the year from Gunn. Point after is good. 21-0 Pittsburgh with 2:02 to go here in the third quarter. Big play for Eric Gill.
Yeah, taking advantage of the field position by the bad punt. Gill makes a big catch down the middle, and it sets up the Tyler Palko touchdown dive. Tyler, talking to Matt Kavanaugh, who has a wealth of experience at that quarterback position, great quarterback in his own right here at the University of Pittsburgh, and then in the NFL at numerous occasions with a couple different teams, and great player in the NFL, great player in college, and really a great coach and a good guy to sit down and talk with, very knowledgeable, very understanding of how he wants to get his points across, and it's a great sounding board for a young quarterback.
Took his lumps last year in Baltimore, where they have had all kinds of quarterback struggles since they let Trent Dilfer go. That quarterback spot in Baltimore hasn't been the same, and Matt, you know, got the short end of it at the end of last season.
Because I still think the genius is still the head coach there, if I'm not mistaken. So they're still struggling without Matt.
Yeah. Kick off for the Panthers.
That they are.
The Huskies, number nine.
Their quarterback situation is in the same ballpark as Syracuse. Not real good.
That ballpark is pretty slim pickings, that's for sure.
Here's Brentel with a kick. Some running room, maybe some life for Connecticut.
They can really use it.
26 yards on the return. That was a pretty nice job in there. Darius Butler brought it back. That time Flosky.
Just as we wanted to see the Pitt offense go downtown and go over the top, it's time for Matt Bonislawski to start picking out these wide receivers and see if he can move the football with a little bit more efficiency through the air.
Under two to play, third period. If they fill the air with football, oh boy. Good pick, Josh Lay. They do catch it, but it hasn't been for big yardage. Got it into Brendan Young.
Josh Lay is playing a good corner today, and they need to play well. You know, this defense is set up by Paul Rose, the defense coordinator, to put these cornerbacks on an island. Sometimes they're out there all by themselves, so they have to play, you know, with a good presence of mind and take shots out there on the edge.
Bonislawski, 14 of 25, 116 is yardage on a stretch play. Boy, good job by Pittsburgh. They run this stretch play and gets nowhere. Good job in there by Darren Thomas, sophomore out of Forestville, Maryland, and H.B. Blake gets his fit.
I think this Pitt football team, especially defensively, they're moving around a lot better than they were earlier in the year. You see him fighting away the block of Keith Gray, the center, as H.B. Blades, and the first guy there is Thomas, 39. So they're running much better to the football.
Well, you look at the Pittsburgh season at Ohio, at Nebraska,
that's
week 2 and 3.
That's their entire season.
No question about it. Overtime loss at Ohio, two picks brought back. And there's a sack, a one-arm sack. How about Chris McKillop, the sophomore from Expert, Pennsylvania? Nice play by big number 41. Well, one-hander.
We were talking about the strength and conditioning of the Panthers. This time, the strength and conditioning of McGillip does a great job of fighting off the block of Grant Preston. One hand and one arm takes down the big quarterback. Matt Bonislawski, 6'4", 222, so not a small quarterback.
Third sack of the day for Pittsburgh. See if they go after this one. Vaceris. Tremendous hang time this time. And running up to get it. Terrell Revis winds up picking up about 5 yards. I think the word we want to look for that we can say on family TV is chutzpah. We'll just leave it at that.
That's right.
40 yards on the punt. Timeout. Actually, the third quarter has run out. 21-0 Pittsburgh.
Enjoy drinking Guinness at a tailgating party.
Yes, and I've discovered that the local custom is to wear cheese on your head. So, to fit in, I brought along some hunks of Limburger.
Limburger cheese heads? Brilliant! Brilliant!
I'm not so sure we're fitting in.
I smell feet.
Whatever the occasion, drink responsibly.
Brilliant!
If you're looking for answers from an auto parts store, get ready. Advance Auto Parts is working harder to help you save money by doing it yourself. Get ready for certified experts who are ready to help. Get ready for answers on any project you can easily understand. Get ready for in-depth information from Advanced TV, our exclusive in-store how-to network. Get ready to go from no way to know-how. For all the advice you'll ever need, the first place to go is Advance Auto Parts. We're ready in advance.
It's the final days of Pontiac's new release party. Your chance to experience the most new models in our history. Get to your dealer by November 14th for a limited time new release bonus on the purchase or lease of a new G6 coupe, an award-winning G6 sedan. The Pontiac G6 starts at $16,490. Pontiac's new release bonus ends November 14th. Don't be late. Pontiac, designed for action. During Number One Cochrane's November sales blitz, you'll save big on more makes, models, and colors than you can imagine.
I like them all, except the browns. Just not into the browns.
Now, at Number One Cochrane, look for Pontiac G6 sedans from just $159 a month. GMC Envoy 4x4s from $279 a month, plus tons more. Hurry to Number One Cochrane before the clock runs out.
Pool tables, game tables, bars and bar stools, it's all at West Penn Billiards, the number one dealer in the USA.
No one else has more fun than West Penn Billiards.
If you're buying or building your dream home, call Irwin Bank for your mortgage or construction loan. You can enjoy your new home with affordable financing and flexible options, like our special first-time home buyer program. Irwin Bank, we exceed your expectations.
Remember. The original Chip Chopped Ham, on special this week at Giant Eagle.
That's defensive coordinator Paul Rhodes with his back to you with his hands on the tips there. His defensive unit has done a very nice job today. Pitching a shutout as we enter the fourth quarter. Dave Sims and Jack and Jimmy with you. This is the Big East Football Conference Game of the Week. Panthers take over. And it's like a heavy dose of run game here as Stephen Howling thrown down hard. Pretty good run. Butler got him. Danny Lansana was there as well.
Dave, when you look at Stephen Howling, you almost think like you can't wait for him to get through the back end of that hole because he's got acceleration. He's got terrific speed, and we saw that against Syracuse. But today he just hasn't been able to get through that second gear and that second level of the defense of Connecticut.
Ankle injury a couple of weeks ago slowed him down a little bit. On the stretch play left side for about three. That time Marvin Taylor brings down Stephen Talley. Pitt now would love to just play Grando right now. Kill some clock, get another score on the board.
Yeah. Play Sluggo right now. It's third and three. And this is what Dave Wonsett was talking to us yesterday about. There's a time and place where you have to run the football. And you have to bone up as an offensive line and be dominant. And right now, Connecticut trying to get their offense back onto the field. So a big third down early in this fourth quarter.
Third and three, Pitt at its own 48. Here's Falco. He's got time. He's going to run it. Lansana, and then, oh, man, Falco took a wicked shot. And incomplete to LaRod Stephen Talley. How about the closing speed of Danny Lansana? That was a football play.
Yeah. He had nasty intentions, and that's a good football play. Danny Lansana, the sophomore from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, comes back to his home state and lays out Tyler Palco. Tyler's a tough quarterback, but you take one too many of those, you get to the sidelines in a hurry.
Cumulative effect, not a lot of laughs there. Gonna run it down. Gressel, aiming for the corner. Oh, he got a nice saw. Oh, that's beautiful. Like a kid, Jimmy wedge shot from about 98 yards. Beautifully done. 48 yards on the kick. And things just get worse for Connecticut.
Look at this.
It's awesome. And I love being a trader.
living for the moment, baby.
Is that all we're about? I mean, I love being a trader, but I also have an investing side. Like, I want to open a B&B.
B&B?
Time to embrace your investing side? At Ameritrade, you'll find products and services to help you plan and invest for your goals.
I have been thinking about opening a dance school.
Let's do some moves.
Join now and get up to 35 free trades and $100 cash.
Red 21! Red! Prime rib! Season seared! Slow roasted at Outback!
Try something bold. Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
I'm open! I'm open!
Julie, I mean, you take me to Outback for their new Heart of Gold bronze filet with sautéed artichokes, sun-dried tomatoes, and a light lemon Alfredo sauce.
Yes, I will.
Try something bold. Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
Before you go here, before you attempt this, and before you even think about going there, you need to go here. Cooper Discoverer Tires, built to take you just about anywhere. Cooper Tires, don't give up a thing.
Purchase a qualified American Standard system and make no payments until 2007. Call Harold Ziegler Heating and Cooling.
21-0 Pittsburgh. Dave wants that, getting his guys, keeping them in the game right now. Time now for a Guinness game summary. Blocked punt. Revis blocked it, and it was returned by Josh Lay, 71 yards. How about Connecticut? Final play, first half, stopped on the 1-8 line. Time of possession, you'd think Connecticut, you look at that number, tells you how deceiving numbers can be. You'd think they'd be up big. Instead, they're on the short end. Look out, here's Bonislav stepping up, firing deep. Battle for it down there. Knocked away, penalty flag. Revis on the coverage with Jason Williams, the intended receiver. Pretty good throw by Bonislavski. My goodness, he got that after 55 yards.
Pass interference. Defense, number 25. 15-yard penalty. Automatic. First down.
Jack Kramer, the referee today.
You can tell how pleased the crowd is, but that right arm looked like it was in early, but in early, he made a play on the ball. I don't see the contact drawing the flag there, Dave.
Unless he said it was a couple of, maybe a step or two before that, because that one looks kind of in.
Yeah, as the ball comes down, there's definitely not contact by Revis. That was a good play. He may have called something 10 or 15 yards before we were able to see it, but on that play, I don't think it draws the flag.
Play fake, here's Bonislavski. It opens up for him. And he'll slide down. Josh Lay jumps over. How about the fact that Connecticut's starting field position has been just brutal here in the second half. Average starting position, their own 16-yard line, while Pitt has started at its own 42.
And the problem has been cashing in. They've been able to go the distance. They have to take 3 points off the scoreboard, and then they get a blocked kick on a field goal attempt, and that hurts any team if you get a block kick, but then you turn it into 7 points, and Randy Edsel's over on his sideline just scratching his head, saying, where are our opportunities going to come from next?
They need some cha-ching here. Bonislavski throws short. It'll give him that all day. McLean with the catch.
Yeah, you almost want to go into some type of hurry-up offense now. Down 21 points, and the clock is ticking away with close to 12 minutes left to go in this game. You have to have some sense of urgency to get down and get a quick score.
Bonislavski, a surprise starter. Randy Edsel had him in warm-ups in sweat. Then when they come out of the tunnel, he was ready to play and dressed with the helmet and pads on. He's 15 of 26, 119, Brockington. Much to speak of there. Let me give you a guess who made the tackle. A guy named Blade.
He's always around the football, Dave.
Stellar. Not a stealer. He's stellar today. Although we are in Pittsburgh. Remember one time we were a couple years
stellar.
Ago?
Stellar. Yeah, you were. Well, you didn't understand that when they said that? Stellar.
They play the Browns tomorrow.
That's right.
And everybody's a little bit revved up with Cleveland coming down.
Now you got to take a shot. You get your first down to the 30-yard line, put it up top.
On the 30, first and 10, they blitz on the edge. It's picked up, throwing deep middle, and he's got Murray as tight end. Murray picks up the first down to the 42-yard line. So Murray with a nice catch, gain of 12. John, you're right about it. There's no
Let's
urgency.
Let's go. Let's get up to the line and get another play called. Good job by Bonis Larcy coming down and throwing the football over the middle. He had wideouts open on the outside, chose to go down the middle. Sam Bryant on the tackle, but you're wasting time in the huddle if you're Connecticut. Get up and get to the line of scrimmage, call the play, and let's go.
Now three scores. Brockington turned away. Can he make something out of it? Well, he did well to get back to the line of scrimmage. Horn, J.J. Horn was there. Phil Tillman, I think, turned him away. His first look from Brockington up front. J.J. the number three tackler on this ball club behind H.B. Blades and Tez Morris.
Yeah, another senior on that defense from Franklin, Pennsylvania. J.J.'s been a big part of this defense for the last couple of years, doing a nice job on that weak side linebacker position.
Second, we'll call it a long 10. Tight end Murray resetting. They rush four. Bonislawski back to throw. And got nothing there. The coverage must be outstanding. And a penalty flag back upfield. After Bonislawski broke out and picked up yardage to about the 47-yard line. So they picked up about seven. But it's coming back.
Holding. Offense number 64. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Still second down.
William Beatty, redshirt freshman from York, Pennsylvania, not too far from where Randy Etzel grew up.
And there's a lot of guys on this Connecticut team that are youthful, and a lot of guys from Pennsylvania on this team trying to make the plays today. Here's your hold here. Here's 64 on the outside. There's the takedown as Bonifarsi steps up into the pocket. But William Beatty had a handful of a Pitt defensive linemen.
Randy Etzel from Glen Rock, Pennsylvania, his brother Duke, well-known official working the A-10 and ACC games. Second down and 20. Throwing short. And here's Paul. Haven't seen him in a while. And looks like he does pick up the first down Pitt territory at the 47-yard line. So they needed that desperately. Gain of 21.
There you get a little dose of Terry Cauley and he gets to show you the speed to the outside. He ran away from Pitt defenders. Good catch and great acceleration. Once Terry catches this football, watch the acceleration to the outside. He's gone right around Clint Sessions, and he's gone. Good job and good play by Cauley to pick up the first down.
9:50 to go. Hole here for Brockington. And Blade tracks him down. Nice gain there by Brockington. Picked up about nine on that play.
H.B. Blades with the tackle. That's a Husky first down.
Take a look at our Outback Steakhouse outstanding back of the game. And I think this is an easy call.
Oh, yeah. I'm just going to put an ER on here. He's the outstanding backer because he's done a terrific job getting to the football, and he leads the Big East with total tackles, almost 120 tackles.
Outback Steakhouse, outstanding back of the game. Here's Bonislawski. Slant, good effort. Can't connect with Jason Williams.
Yeah, the play before, Dave, he's just going from his middle linebacker position and tracking down Brockington, the running back, but he has a nose for the football, and you know, take a look at those eyes. You know, he's very focused, very determined young man, and he's only a junior from Plantation, Florida. He's got a great bloodline of defensive play.
First team all conference as the strong side backer last year. And Brockington gets close to first down yardage, brought down by Tez Morrison. I'm trying to think.
who else is playing a better? I mean, there's some good middle linebackers in the league.
Oh yeah.
I'm trying to think who's playing better in the league right now, middle linebacker.
There may be some defensive players that are on par, but no one's playing better than H.B. Blake.
Third down and one here for Connecticut. Clock runs at 8:35 down, 21-0. Onislavsky is going to fold in. Ooh, he didn't get much of a push there. Gus Mistakis, number 93, was there to make the stop.
Well, I know why he didn't get a lot of push, because that clavicle is telling him, get down. I don't know why you take a chance with a quarterback sneak. You might want to hand that football off, because one good shot on that shoulder and he could be on the shelf for the rest of the year.
Pittsburgh with touchdowns in each of the first three quarters. Palco to Bukas, the tight end, 2 yards and a pass, a play action, 7-0. Second quarter, Lay a 71-yard return of a blocked field goal, 14-0. And then 2:02 left in the third, Palco a 1 yard run. And that was highlighted, that drive was highlighted by Gill's 22-yard run and catch. Phil Tillman, the injured player. Bills out of Edgewood, Maryland, with the Valley Forge Military Academy. Seen a lot of their graduates. A lot of guys come out of high school, go to Valley Forge Military for post-grad.
Yeah.
Rasheed Marshall played at West Virginia the last few years. He came out of there, among others. I think, Larry Fitzgerald was there as well.
I think so.
Yeah. 8:23 and counting for Connecticut. First and 10 at the Pitt 26. High snap. Pretty good protection. Running a corner route, and that's broken up. Ball was there.
Yeah, Sam Bryant.
Nice job. Sam Bryant, the junior from Reading, PA.
Yeah, you called it, Dave. Sam Bryant on the coverage. Next two balls that the defenders have broken up but not come down with the interception. Tez Morris had one early, and now Sam Bryant cuts underneath the receiver, Brandon Young. You think he has the catch, but the ball gets by him. Didn't go up and catch it with his hands early. The ball gets by him and into his body. And he can't come down. Yes, it's a breakup, but if you're a defensive coach, you want to come down with that. He has two interceptions on the season, looking to make it three.
12th play of this drive, 5.5 minutes taken off the clock. Good time. Bonaslavski's got all day. Throwing into double coverage, and it is. That one's intercepted. That one, Josh Lane got it. So Connecticut turned away again. First pick of the day for Bonaslavski. Josh Lay with the 71-yard return of a blocked field goal, the second score of the day for Pittsburgh.
Well, the ball, Dave, just hangs up there a little bit too long, and he throws into double coverage. Josh comes down with the interception.
Tried to get it into Jason Williams, but to no avail. Pittsburgh in control with 8 minutes to go.
If you're looking for answers from an auto parts store, get ready. Advance Auto Parts is working harder to help you save money by doing it yourself. Get ready for certified experts who are ready to help. Get ready for answers on any project you can easily understand. Get ready for in-depth information from Advance TV, our exclusive in-store how-to network. Get ready to go from no way to know-how. For all the advice you'll ever need, the first place to go is Advance Auto Parts.
We're ready in advance.
People have been waiting for this game for a long time. In fact, the fans are already out in force. The marching band is here as well. Coming up on the canvas, kickoff.
Hey! 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 Hey!
Hey!
Ah, football. Are you in good hands?
It's the final days of Pontiac's new release party. Your chance to experience the most new models in our history. Get to your dealer by November 14th for a limited time new release bonus on the purchase or lease of a new G6 coupe, an award-winning G6 sedan. The Pontiac G6 starts at $16,490. Pontiac's new release bonus ends November 14th. Don't be late. Pontiac, designed for action.
The O'Reilly Auto Parts All-College Classic features West Virginia against Oklahoma and Tennessee against Oklahoma State in a basketball doubleheader. For tickets, call 405-236-5000.
Room Concepts, affordable living and dining furniture in Warrendale and Whitehall.
With AutoTrader.com, you can choose from over 2 million vehicles. Just type in what you're looking for, and we'll help you find the car you really want on the PittsburghChannel.com.
Steelers football Sunday night means special times for ABC shows. Catch America's Funniest Home Videos Sunday afternoon at 1, then Extreme Makeover Home Edition at 2. After the game, an all-new Desperate Housewives Sunday late night at 12:30 a.m., followed by an all-new Grey's Anatomy at 1:30 a.m.
Bastard, you get your eyes on me! If you don't know, you have to see me on the field! Don't you tell me you don't know the call! Do you understand?
I understand.
Great stop.
Message received.
Wait a minute.
Here's Pittsburgh looking to run out the spot. Paul Rose. That's why I played offense. You know, I mean, we'd come back and say, hey, you know, why don't we just, you know, maybe throw the comeback and try to get open on that, all right? Okay. You know, maybe the offensive line, but we kind of talk. You know, sometimes we raise our voice. But defensive guys, they're always in that upper echelon of voice.
What do you think his blood pressure was? What do you think his blood pressure?
Well, Dave, I think it's pretty high.
His blood pressure was up there on the scale pretty high.
And Paul, you know, in talking with him yesterday, real calm and real, you know, you could tell he's got that fiery side, boy, but not until game day do you really see it. And I think he has to rest. He goes into total bed rest for 6 days. Just to get ready for Saturday. Oh, he's a very energetic and a really good defensive coach, and Dave wants that. Very happy to have him coaching on the sideline.
Wants that kept. If Paul Rhodes wanted the job, so did Matt Kavanaugh. Wants that winds up getting it and keeps both guys. Falco slant getting it broken up there by Darius Butler. Third straight three and out for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, this Pitt offense has struggled in the second half a little bit. They were put in great field position by a bad punt, and they did capitalize on that. But when you take a look at Connecticut, they've had bad field position, and when they had opportunities, they just couldn't do it offensively. Couldn't do enough offensively to get in this football game.
Gressel standing inside his 10 at the 6-yard line. 6:29 to go. Connecticut never got close. Low line drive and well covered by the Panthers. Take a break here from Pittsburgh. The Panthers are in control at the 6:17 mark, leading by score 21-0.
Enjoy drinking Guinness at a tailgating party.
Yes, and I've discovered that the local custom is to wear cheese on your head. So, to fit in, I brought along some hunks of Limburger.
Limburger cheese heads? Brilliant!
Brilliant!
I'm not so sure we're fitting in.
I smell feet.
Whatever the occasion, drink responsibly.
Brilliant!
You know, if you're having a bunch of guys over to watch synchronized swimming, forget it. Just serve them weenies. But if you're watching football, you better be grilling Johnsonville brats. Look at them. They're big, fresh, always juicy, and perfect with that other home team favorite. When you give the fans what they want, well, welcome to football party heaven. Welcome to Johnsonville.
It's the final days of Pontiac's new release party. Your chance to experience the most new models in our history. Get to your dealer by November 14th for a limited time new release bonus on the purchase or lease of a new G6 coupe, an award-winning G6 sedan. The Pontiac G6 starts at $16,490. Pontiac's new release bonus ends November 14th. Don't be late. Pontiac, designed for action.
American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning.
Purchase a qualified American Standard system and make no payments until 2007. Call Geary Heating and Cooling.
That is the Fort Pitt Tunnel heading out of town, back to the airport, 21-0. Actually heading into town, beg your pardon, there's the Steel City. And we've taken it many a time. It's one of the great scenics in the U.S. of A. 6:17 to go on the clock here in the fourth quarter. It's been a long afternoon. Missed opportunities for the Connecticut Huskies. Bonislawski, nice run there. Picks up the first down at the 49-yard line. That's not good. He landed on that left side, and that's the side that he injured. The ball was recovered by the center, by William Beatty, the left tackle. Talking about missed opportunities down their own eight. Made the blocked field goal. That was taken in for six. On down, and then the interception.
Yeah, 15-play drive and a 12-play drive, and you get 0 points out of it.
Look out, Bonifacio goes down. There was a nifty move by Charles Sillette. That's the fourth sack of the day by Pittsburgh. What a move he put on the left tackle.
Yeah, William Beatty.
Woo. Talk about a shake move.
Little swim move and then some speed to the quarterback to get Bonifacio down.
Loss of nine, and Connecticut going no huddle here. Blitz coming again. Bonifacio throws it away. Penalty flag.
And they're going to get a hold on Sillette that time. He's becoming too much to handle for the left tackle. There's been multiple guys playing that position, and no one's been able to handle him.
So that second and 20, they'll undoubtedly decline this, bring up a third and 19. It's been a long afternoon for Andy Etzel's club. They put up numbers between the 20s and nothing on the board.
And it's been a long time since they've had that number, Dave, at seven penalties for 63 yards.
They averaged just about 48 yards a game. That's the fewest. They came in as the least penalized team in the Big East Conference. 5:27 to go in the fourth. Bonifacio throws. Yeah, there it is on the second grab. It's intercepted. They got a chance to get something here. And that's Sam Bryant.
Sam Bryant
had his hands on one earlier. Comes back to get another return of 40 yards. Sam Bryant. His first pick of the season, junior from Reading, Pennsylvania, took over for Mike Phillips, who suffered a dislocated ankle versus Nebraska back in week three.
At 21-0, you've got to start pushing the football down the field and taking some chances. That time, it was a matter of Matt Bonislawski just trying to make a play or give his receiver a chance to make the play, but an overthrow right to Sam Bryant. He gets it on the second catch. He bobbled it the first time and catches it this time. He gets that interception, his third on the season.
The Panthers with 5:15 left on the clock. In good shape with the ball. And they'll run up the middle. That's a good hard run there by Rashad Jennings. He's their power back. Pittsburgh looking to go 4-2 in the Big East Conference. Connecticut closing in on dropping to 1-4. So with 11 on the bench for the Panthers.
You mentioned on that last run, Rashad Jennings showing you his power. He's just getting to 100%. He's been banged up all year, but that run looked like he was closer than ever.
Jennings and Murphy in the eye behind Falco. Jennings cuts inside his fullback across the 25. Would be about a yard and a half short of the first down. Got it to the 24-yard line. Got to be a very demoralizing loss for Connecticut. End opportunities, get to the last couple of seconds of the first half, put a field goal on the board, a penalty against Pittsburgh. Randy Edelman decides to go for it. Brockington gets denied, running off the right guard, and it's been it's more downhill from there. 26-yard punt sets up Pittsburgh in a short field possession, and Talco takes it in from a yard out. This is Jim Murphy. He got straightened up and driven back by Tyvon Branch. But it is good for first down.
Yep, Dave wants that, trying to get it to the senior on a third down conversion. Tim Murphy doing a nice job of moving those legs.
Last home game of the 05 season for Pittsburgh.
Well, they've got one more game on their schedule, and they've got it circled, and for good reason, because they're playing a good football team down in Morgantown.
Panthers are going to go to 4-0 in home games in the conference, and 5-1 overall. Jennings trying to get to the edge. Stiff arm didn't serve him well there. Good play by Ryan Hennigan, the middle linebacker. West Virginia, what a game that's going to be. ESPN will carry it, 8 p.m. Eastern time start. Chris Masalo on the right, the director of operations. Matt Cavanaugh on your left.
Yeah, that's going to be a big one, especially down at Morgantown at night. And you hope the weather stays a little bit like this today, but I don't think so. It's going to get a little bit nasty, I believe, on that evening.
And a night game of Thanksgiving in Morgantown. Falco, ooh, good defensive play. Sure was. Hargrave in a hurry from Pleasantville, New Jersey. Preston Richard at the river from Philadelphia. John, Pleasantville has one of the longest public golf courses in America. My old man used to play there. You should come down there and play.
I want to see that one.
It is huge. Today's game has been brought to you by Cooper Tires, proud to be the official tire of the Big East Conference. Cooper Tires, don't give up a thing. Guinness Draft Stout, drink responsibly. Brilliant. Outback Steakhouse, no rules, just right. And by Pontiac, 10 models, each one designed for action. Here's a look at Dan the Man, his trophy, looking at the final path, the reenactment of the path to John Brown. And there's his banner along with Tony Dorsett. Tremendous football tradition here at the University of Pittsburgh. Marshall Goldberg, Joe Schmidt's number.
There's an old Merino jersey.
You want those throwbacks back? Is what
Man, absolutely. Look how much, look at the difference in jerseys. I mean, yeah, that's Pitt.
That's what the old timers want, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna stand up as an old timer. You're right. We want them back
with this script.
Panthers coming out with a third and 12 in the Connecticut 24.
I have a feeling Dave wants that. If he can make it happen, he's going to bring back those throwback jerseys and make them permanent. Third and 12. Falco looking for man downfield, tight end there, caught, touchdown. Dropped it. Looked like Gil had it for six. Broken up by Marvin Taylor.
Good pressure on Falco by the Connecticut front seven. They did a good job of collapsing the pocket on Falco. And Tyler did a nice job of just getting the ball close. He eludes pressure and gets the ball close down the by the goal line to Eric Gil. Gil adjusts his ball. He looks like he's going to make the easy catch, but just drops the football.
First field goal attempt today by Josh Cummings, who's 13 of 17. This from 42 yards out. Adam Gressel to hold. Boy, he struck that nicely, didn't he?
Yes.
Right through the upright. He's now 4 out of 7 in that 40 to 49 yard range. So another three on the board for the Pitt Panthers, 24-0. And let's take a look at our Pontiac game-changing performance. And there's a no doubt about her here. It was the blocked field goal right here.
Yeah, Darrell Rivas comes untouched. He gets the block, and then his partner in crime, Bernard Josh Lay, takes it 71 yards for the Panthers touchdown. And remember, Connecticut going in to score off of a long drive. They had a chance to really get back into this football game, but this changed the complexion of what happened in the plays to come, and that was Rivas and Lay that changed it.
Cummings, a 42-yard field goal here, 2:24 to go. And Rivas came in, you're right, John. I mean, nobody laid a glove on him.
Josh Lay with a a touchdown and an interception today.
Adam Bristol on the kick for the Panthers.
2:24 to go here in the fourth. A long afternoon for the Huskies. Connecticut season winding down. West Virginia awaits Pittsburgh. Here's the kick. And bobbled, taken by Butler. He's in the clear with two men to beat. No flags to this point. Butler reverses, stays with it, and carries all the way down to the 26-yard line. A fabulous return by Butler, and is brought down by Reggie Carter. A kickoff return of 64 yards. Total yards, Connecticut 292, Pitt 191, but Connecticut on the short end.
Yeah, you get the bobble in the beginning, but then the speed to the outside. Good return by Butler and puts Connecticut inside the 30-yard line.
Only Butler's Butler came in with one return for 24 yards. That's a career best. Freshman out of Tamarack, Florida. And Cauley is ridden out of bounds. Picks up about three.
This is a Connecticut team, Dave, that has been just a ton of injuries this year, and they've got a lot of kids that they've redshirted, and Randy Etzel said he doesn't want to burn a redshirt on these kids coming down the stretch. They want to regroup, and they've got a new facility coming in next year that'll be completed that they're very excited about, that's going to help with recruiting and help keep kids that they want committed to this program. So the future is bright for the Huskies.
Second year in the Big East Conference for the Connecticut Huskies in football. The 1AA member, member of the Yankee Conference for a lot of years, independent. Bonislavski throws short. They call it. Bonislavski got drilled. He took a big hit from Charles Sillette. Matt's hanging in there.
Yeah, he is. And probably wondering, man, I should have kept those sweats on I had in pregame, because I've taken a beating today. And it's been a lot of times where he's had to slide and just adjust his body to not take a big shot, but he's hung in there this entire time. And let's not forget, he's coming back from that clavicle injury, his left clavicle, on October 7th against Syracuse. He hurt early in that football game.
They started with Bonislavski in sweats, had his uniform top on, no pads, just warming up. Randy Etzel didn't want to let Pittsburgh know that he was going to make that quarterback change until they came out for the game time. Throwing over the middle, intercepted again. If there's any legs here, he's got six. Cauley made the save, a 28-yard return.
Tez Morris doing a great job of stepping up in front, the senior from Hamilton, Ohio. Looked like he could go the distance, but Terry Cauley, the running back, catches him. Great way to finish off your home season as a senior out of Hamilton, Ohio.
Third pick today by the Panthers, and it's a good thing Cauley was there. Three of the last four passes have been intercepted by the Panthers. Final home game of the 05 season. Time now for Pittsburgh to just run it out. Marcus Furman, first time we've seen him today. Marcus, a senior out of Connellsville, Pennsylvania. Connecticut has two timeouts remaining.
Yeah, Tez Morris celebrating on the sideline. The only four-year starter that the Panthers have, and a well-deserved handshake. Good job of anticipating that throw.
Falco letting the clock run off here. Furman getting the carry and brought down by Marvin Taylor. Taylor, number 10, coming up from the free safety spot. So it looks like they're just, Randy Etzel's going to let this one run out. Get out of town while you can. Connecticut still has two games remaining on the 26th. South Florida will come to East Hartford, and Louisville will come to East Hartford on December 3.
Connecticut. That'll give them some time to get some of those bodies maybe healthy, because that South Florida team's got some terrific team speed.
And they'll run Furman again. The senior gets another call. And that's going to do it right there. That is your ball game, folks. Pittsburgh Panthers victorious today. A shutout, 24-0 over the Connecticut Huskies. Pittsburgh improves to 4-2 in conference play. And they go to 5-5 overall. Connecticut 1-4 in the conference and 4-5 overall. Panthers made a bunch of big plays. Bonaslavski and Falco. What do your quarterbacks always talk about after the game?
You know, just the same old thing. How's everything going? How you feeling? Your shoulder okay? Hey, good luck the rest of the way. Stay healthy.
And you buy next time I see you, right?
And it's on you the next time. I've got one up on you. If I was Matt, I would have said to Tyler, hey, keep 51 away from
me. Hey, honest to goodness, our outstanding back of the game. His name, H.B. Blaine, up around 12 tackles.